Coming to you live from their studio in South Florida, Twist Gaming. Featuring lead broadcaster, Matt Koza. Co-host and creative genius, Josh Perry. Co-host and interviewer extraordinaire, Anne Lazito. Co-host and marketing mogul, Aaron Murphy. With appearances from special guest, Lucy. Welcome to Twist Gaming, where you get to play board games with us. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. This is Twist Gaming, where you get to play board games with us. We are coming to you live here from our studio in sunny South Florida, bringing you another episode of Twitch Plays Aeon Trespass Odyssey, which just finished up on Kickstarter 2 days ago.
Yep, Monday.
Is that 2 days ago?
Yep.
I think so. But first up, who are we? I'm Matt.
I'm Josh. And Anne's over there.
Anne's over there. The empty seat you see over here is Anne. She didn't want to be here for when the show started today because she said she didn't want to be dealing with the minutia of having to deal with you folks at home. But she will come in whenever her heart desires later. She's gotten a very big head recently. But in all seriousness, Anne's working on some actual adult work stuff right now. But she'll be jumping on in just a few moments. But we didn't want to delay any further because we love all you guys at home. But let's get a little recap going. So what happened last week on Twitch Plays ATO? Besides Anne not being there either.
We killed the Hecaton.
Okay.
And then we backtracked on the map a bunch.
We did.
And then we found the maze.
The corn?
Yeah. It was a maze made of corn. Yeah. It's a maze, maze of maze.
Maze, maze of maze.
Yeah.
What? Those are my keys. Anne is going to destroy my car now. Anne's going out for a drive instead of streaming with us right now.
Just drinking and driving.
Drinking and driving. Yeah. But, okay, so yes. We backtracked. We found Minos, or we found the area where Minos might be, but there's a bull. Like, we heard there's a bull. No bull. We're going to fight a bull today.
Yeah. Oh, wait. I think.
Oh, wait.
The end of that story, didn't we all, the people who were not in their tight end started with something, right?
Yes.
And I don't remember what that was. Was it one danger each?
I believe that it was a danger.
Yeah, okay. So that's why Twitch has a danger and I have two danger because I got danger for something.
That's correct, yeah. So we did make a note of that. Okay. See, we were smart. We made a note of it beforehand. So we are going to go and fight the... What the hell is this thing called again? Go ahead, Josh. All right, go for it.
The Labyrinth Aros.
Yeah, Labyrinth Aros. Yeah, I'll take it. I think that's right. But I need one more thing from you, Josh.
Yeah.
I need the magic.
Rah!
Okay. So we have set up the board as per the directions there. So let's go over briefly what this Labyrinthoros is, does, all that fun stuff. So he has... Oh, it looks like he... Does this mean he attacks on the sides, Josh?
I have no idea what that means.
Oh, that's... Okay. Let's see. So he is a level 1, so he's going to move 7 spaces. It's going to be a 7 plus to hit. He has 10 life, and he starts with no traits in play. His signature move is the charge, so he's going to attack the furthest Titan in front in range for 2 dice at 10 plus each. So pretty not great. For those of you that are joining us for the first time with ATO or need a quick refresher, the way that this game works is we are all playing as Argonauts, and we are controlling essentially organic mechs. He starts with Trample and Labyrinth. It doesn't say the whole thing. We are playing as Argonauts that are... Oh, yes, it does say all Trample Labyrinth. I can't read. Okay, so it's under the all section. So Trample and Labyrinth, I'll grab that out. We're Argonauts... Trample Labyrinth. Piloting flesh mechs known as...
Titans.
Thank you. I can't speak today. And we're fighting the baddies, which are known as Primordials. So essentially, we're in a like post-apocalyptic, where the gods fell, ancient Greece type thing going on.
Yeah, it's us. The gods were killed some way. They're gone.
Yeah.
Steampunky.
Yeah.
Greek time.
Steampunk.
They
Greek
use
town.
What's the cool thing that they use? What is it called?
Heliopile?
Yeah, an
Aelopile.
Aelopile.
Yeah. Aelipoli, whatever it's
called.
Which
would have advanced technology really quickly if it took on.
Yeah. If it took off.
Yeah.
Like it flew.
So what's the trait that starts with, Pat?
Hold on. So the way it fights, also, did you guys learn about your exhaust misunderstanding?
Yes.
Sure did, yeah.
Yes,
so we'll explain that for anyone that might have missed last week also. So we're going to take turns, the monster being one turn and then another turn being all of us going in whatever respective order we want, taking our movement and our action to either like activate our weapons or interact with the terrain or something to that extent.
Yeah.
We've got unique weapons all the way around. That one viewer, and I'm sorry I missed your name, was referring to is that we have some weapons within our respective stashes. Where the hell did I put everything? Oh, right there. And I'm going to show off my... Oh, I lost my crossbow. Yeah, it broke last time.
Yeah.
So, Anne's weapon has that, no? Or was it yours?
Twitch's weapon
has it. I knew someone's weapon. No, that was their old weapon.
No, the new one has it.
New one, too? Okay. So, it has exhaust, attack, or block. So, that's not... We originally thought that it was exhaust to perform an additional attack or block. It is whenever you attack or block, you need to exhaust. To unexhaust, you would take your activation on your turn to... on exhaust your card.
Yep.
So the anatomy of the weapons, you've got the number of dice that you need to roll, the accuracy modifier, so it's going to be whatever the monster's to hit is, and then you subtract this from that number.
Yep.
And then which damage dice they're rolling. So in this case, you got the black Kratos die plus one break.
Yep.
So breaks equal damage. You have the ATO field on the different body part locations for the primordials. If your breaks meet or beat that, you actually get a damage.
Hey. I think it's in the fridge.
Cool. So that is that. The two cards that the Primordial has in play, the two trade cards, they've got Trample. So Trample is full move Labyrinthoros in a straight line. Every Titan it moves through suffers knockdown. Every knockdown Titan it moves through immediately draws an Obel. Oh. Obel is 50-50 death, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Or 50-50 life.
Glass half full. And then displacement is knockback one. So explain to me how knockdown works, Joshua.
There's a condition card. You get knocked down, and basically you get knocked down until the start of your next turn.
And then you get back up again.
And you'll get back up again. You're never going to keep you down. Wow. It's almost like you could have just asked us to delay 5 more minutes for you to get here. But that's cool. So then we've got the Labyrinth. And the Labyrinth is place a break token on this card on any Labyrinth tile above. On this card on any Labyrinth tile above. Oh, okay. Each time you have to place a Labyrinth tile, take the one indicated by the token. Then move the token one space clockwise. Labyrinth X. Place X Labyrinth tiles adjacent to the Primordial's rear. If placed on a Titan, they gain one danger. So how this sounds is that
he poops out a labyrinth.
Yeah, he shits out labyrinths.
Yep. It's 100% how that sounds.
Yeah. Okay, I'm glad we're on the same page here.
He shits mazes.
Yeah.
Well, it's big, it's a maze.
Well, you know what happens when you eat corn.
Yeah. It's the same process.
I'm assuming it's the same way with maize. All right, so I'm going to take a danger token here, and I'm going to add that into the tile. Danger, Will Wobbinthub. No, we're not doing mystical here. All right, Anne, I'm gonna let you pick which one of these that's gonna go on.
I need a minute.
Just pick. Just point to one. Point to one of those. Okay, cool. I don't know why you chose that one, but so I'm assuming that there'll be certain cards on the Labyrinthoros that say Labyrinth X.
Poop maze.
Yeah, poop maze. Poop maze. He's
a manus.
Oh. Mazanus. Oh, goodness. Board game designers hate him because he makes his own game. You know, maze. That was a stretch. You know what else is stretching when he lays those mazes? Anyways, because, I mean, look at the size of it compared to his body. Come on. Anyways, back on track here.
It's a lot of fiber.
There are three main stats that our Titans have. There is Rage, which is basically how often you're attacking and the benefits that you'll get on the Kratos table when you have that Rage. You've got Fate, which is a modifier that you can use to reroll dice, so mitigate some of your bad stuff. But the more Fate you have, the more negative stuff is going to happen to you, such as some of the monster's attacks will do more damage on if when you have a certain level of Fate.
Or hit you more.
Or hit you more. And then finally, there's Danger. And the more danger you have, obviously, the worse. Danger is your damage. So every time you take damage, your danger is going to go up. For each time you take the damage, you are going to draw one of those cards?
A trauma card.
Trauma card.
Every time you get hit.
Every time you get hit, danger. Well,
if you get hit, it's not like you get pushed into a terrain or something.
But if you don't take danger, you wouldn't take a trauma card. For each time you would take danger, any amount of danger. It's not for each danger you take. It's for every grouping of danger that you
take. No, if you get pushed into a terrain, you just take the danger. You don't take a card. That's when you get attacked. You take a trauma.
So when you take danger from an attack.
Yeah, danger from attack.
Okay, so we were both wrong. Cool. You draw one of those trauma cards. The more danger you have, the higher level of trauma card, the worse it's going to be.
And once you get over 9 danger, you draw Oblong.
That's like an Opal card.
Opal.
Which is basically 50-50 life or death. And Josh will actually serenade us with playing the oboe while we talk about these oboe cards. And he's going to also draw them with his elbow.
This isn't Yogi.
Yeah, it is now. So let's talk a little bit about the gear that everyone's got, because you don't know what you got till it's gone. Twitch has this really awesome shield blade that they picked up. So again, I showed it before. It's going to be
maze flesh.
2 attack dies. It is. That means it came out of his butt.
Yeah,
it
came out of his butt.
It's poop.
It's poop. It's a poop shield.
So that is 2 attack dice, +1 accuracy, nah. Black Kratos die, +1.
Would you call it a scat shield?
Why is that funny?
Scat is a nickname for poop. I'm not.
Yeah, but then, like, it should be like a pun. Like you're basing it off of something else that's similar, but you're not.
Did you just apologize? Did you just say sorry to him?
What's the thing under the Triskelion? Is that what you're
asking about? So that's a defense. So if you block, you could roll a red Kratos die, and then for every break you get, you would ignore 1 danger.
Mm-hmm. But again, you would have to exhaust this to block.
Yep.
So I had the crossbow,
life,
which I don't have anymore.
Sucks to be you.
I'm so glad that you joined us. And I'm going to be running around with the Siren Teeth today. So this is a 3 attack dice, 0 accuracy, but red dice for each one. So what that means is when you hit multiple times with attack dice, you don't draw multiple body part cards. For each one that you would hit on, quote unquote, you would add additional ones of your attack bonuses. So if I was to hit with 2 of my 3 dice, I would roll 2 red Kratos die instead of 1.
I knew your dating life was kind of in the dumps, but I didn't think you had stumped so low to go and hit on the bull. I didn't think you were going into interspecies dating.
I don't get it either.
You said hit on! Whatever. It was fun. Don't even start. Whatever. You and your scat shield.
And then on top of that, this is going to give you 1 free opening that you could add to the Kratos pool, and then you get to back away 1, which is move
back
1
it,
away.
Back it up.
Back it up. Say what? And then we all have unique abilities on our Titans also. I'm just skipping over what you have, Josh. You and no one really cares. We all have Rush, which is when you're at 2+ danger, you can spend a fate. And by spend, I mean gain a fate. To move at least 3 spaces up to your maximum movement +1, and you add an extra red die to your wound attempt. And then if you've got a certain number of danger based on your character, beyond
you
that, you can use your secondary ability. So for you all, you have 8, so you're not going to use that unless you get in a really bad spot. But it's Shatterfist, so that is when you attack, gain a danger to gain +1 break.
Did you put the link up on the drive?
No,
for all
I did.
Of these?
I did not.
So we have a Google Photo Drive with pictures. You know, as Matt's kind of explaining this, I'm sure this is one of those things that makes sense in the moment.
We
so
have pictures of us having a fun time, like at the beach, and you know, like going to the store.
I hate that. I have a picture pushing Matt and Josh in a cart. You can check out the link there to refresh and go back and see what everything is after Matt's kind of explained it.
Does it have the new gear on it?
I don't know.
The answer is no. I just wanted to put that out there. I knew the answer. I just wanted to make him answer. But yeah, so that's your ability there. And then on the bottom right-hand side of everyone's character sheet.
You guys are Cersei Guard.
Yeah, you guys are Cersei Guard. So the bottom right, you've got your Kratos table. So this is based off of the amount of rage that you have. Once your attack hits, you're going to do these modifiers. So they stack. So at level 1, you get a break or an opening that you can put on. Level 2, you get a dice reroll. 3, you get more breaks or openings. 4 is pushback or reroll. 5 is you add another red Kratos die, which is awesome. And then 6 is going to be breaks and openings again. And then the last thing I wanted to say is as you're doing damage to the monster, the primordial at the bottom of his body part card is going to be an escalate text, which is essentially as you're wounding the monster, it is going to get stronger. So it's going to discard one of its body part cards, put a arguably tougher one to hit into the pile, and then also escalate one of the lower level AI cards that match the body part card into a higher level one, so he's going to hit harder. So essentially you're ruffling his feathers, and, you know, or in this case making him see red. It's a bull.
I don't get it.
Well, you see, bulls are like Josh, and they can't see colors.
Is that why you wore your red shirt today?
You know, yes, that's why we wore our red shirts today.
You know,
no, Anne wore her green shirt today.
As I was pulling this shirt out of the closet this morning, I laughed to myself because I remembered when you told me that you couldn't see that there was text or imagery on this shirt, my invisible shirt.
All right, so I think we're ready to jump into things, though, right, Josh?
Yep.
Yeah, no. Oh, let's talk about the terrain real quick. Sorry. So we've got the Labyrinth cards here, which is indestructible. If you crash into this tile, stop and gain a danger. Primordials ignore this tile. And then passage, you may move through the path, but not across the red line. So if you look at the tiles, basically you have to go along them lengthwise. It's kind of hard to see in this camera, but Anne, if you could trace the path just so people at home can see, I think they can see the red lines, but not the green lines.
Oh, wait, they're... Oh, so the green lines are at the ends.
There's dashed green lines at the ends, and
yeah.
Basically you're going to follow the path the long way to go through it, but you can't go through the red lines. Then we've got the village. So the village is going to be destructible terrain. If you crash into this tile, gain a danger and remove it. If the primordial moves through this tile, remove it. If the village is inhabited, So if it's removed, you're going to gain a doom. Doom!
Doom!
So I set the thing up at the far end of the table, so hopefully the bull doesn't go for it. And then finally, we've got the forest, and the forest is some cover. So when you're in the forest, gain one defensive Kratos die,
Then
it is destructible. So if you crash into this tile, which means you get pushed into it, you're going to stop, gain a danger, and remove the tile. And if the primordial moves through this tile, you remove it. So
the whole forest is destructible if you trip into it?
Yep.
That's how big these primordial titans are.
It's a domino thing. Like, you hit one tree, and it hits the next tree, and it just all falls down.
Exactly. Isn't the village at most 4 spaces away from the primordial, or did I read it wrong? Maybe I read it wrong. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it said I read it as at least 4 spaces away from the primordial or another village. It's at most 4 spaces away from the primordial.
So is this a custom setup, though? Because there is a special rule that the book has specific setups, and if the book gives you a setup that does not follow the normal rules, you're still supposed to follow the book.
So the special setup is where the labyrinth tiles are. Not the other two were just two random terrains that were drawn.
That makes sense. That makes sense.
Oh, no, we're happy for you to tell us so we can make sure we're playing the right way.
Absolutely.
So, thank you.
So we're sticking in this corner.
And then the last thing is this is an interactive stream. So whenever you guys want to do anything with your character and your character being
Cersei Guard
or Solon is the Titan, just shout out in chat what you want to do. If there's an important decision, we'll put up a poll for you to vote on. And then finally, whenever there's dice to be rolled, I'm going to ask you to roll dice just like this. So you'll see request D10. It'll say everyone roll. And then I need to unreset the die, I think.
Everyone roll!
I thought I unreset it. There it goes. And so it'll put the timer up on the screen. You could either type in !roll, or you could download the extension and hit the roll button. So that's going to keep going until someone rolls, or if someone doesn't roll, eventually it'll pull up a dummy roll. And then, you know, 'tis the season, there's also pumpkin rolls. But in this case, Workanos roll 10.
So hey now.
That's starting us off strong today. It's a good thing we erased that on nothing.
All downhill from now.
Exactly. So with that, let's go ahead and get started. Josh, who goes first?
The Mr. Bull.
Mr. Bull. I feel like that's a little bit of a bull
statement. Did you talk about one of the coolest parts of the game itself, how that mini has interchangeable head and tails?
What?
So the mini doesn't come together, right? Like you have to put some of the components together. And the head and the tail, the butt for the bull, it comes with a couple of different options.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so well, I got to choose which ones and glue them in.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it is kind of cool. So that's our bull.
Bull.
No bull.
No bull. So let's go ahead and start. So the monster or the primordial.
Oh, we need to pick someone who has priority target.
You.
Because we all have.
Josh is the tank, so it's going to be you.
Okay.
You want to get the priority target token out?
You have the token.
Right in front of you.
I'm asking you if you want to get it out.
No.
He wanted to know if you had a deep desire.
I don't know which one it looks like.
It looks like a target.
Yeah.
It should be the front middle.
No. More. No.
More
other
front.
Way. Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that was a thing.
No, the other one. Yep. Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and put it on Josh's. Those are for when he changes forms. It's not even his final form. Okay, Bullseye. Calm it down. Can you put it on your character?
Is it going to confuse you?
No, Joshua.
Just go. You know which one it is.
I hope it kills you. All right. So this feels like a misprint here.
Yeah, that looks like a misprint. That is...
That's an AI card with body part text.
Stuff on it?
So reminder, we do have a prototype version here. So, okay, we'll just redo that one there. There we go. Thank you for the subscription. He's going to do Ram. Whoa, back Black Betty. Ram. So, Josh, he is going to target the furthest Titan in front in range.
It's going to be me.
Which one are you, anyways?
I need the
shield.
Pencil. Please
so,
and thank you.
Pencil. Oh, okay. So, furthest Titan in front in range, and that is you. It is a tie between you and me, but because you got the priority target token, it's going to attack you.
Yep.
So, Anne, can you please move the primordial up to Josh?
Yes. What's the primordial's movement?
Seven. 1, 2, 3,
five,
three,
four,
two,
five,
seven,
six, seven. And then he's going to put his butt in your face.
Oh, is he going to shit a maze on me?
Maybe.
It's going to be
amazing.
So, Josh, this is going to roll 2d10s, and it's a 10-plus for you to dodge this attack. So how much dodge do you have?
I have 2 evasion.
2 evasion. So that means you need to roll 8-plus in order to dodge. So it's probably going to hurt you.
2 tens. 2 critical dodges.
Wow. Okay. So you do something on critical dodges,
I got
right?
a critical evade. I could do knockback 2. But
please don't do that.
But that would hurt you.
Oh, please do that.
All right. So... after attack, he's going to shit on me. It's better for you to knock him back because then he would displace me.
Yes.
And so, displacing doesn't cause damage.
No.
No.
But shitting on
if
me does.
If he displaces you into the maze, it would cause damage.
But does
we
he have
technically...
Does he have to displace me into the maze? Can he
no,
displace
No, it could be any
me?
Direction.
Yeah.
So, have him back up 2 spaces.
So
he's
this
gonna
particular
no,
maze
no,
piece?
No. No.
This particular maze piece... put it in the thing, doesn't have a red line, red border on that side. So you would go...
I feel like it's supposed to. And the only reason I'm saying that, I'm sorry to interrupt you like that, but if you look at the way it's printed, there's like an excessive amount of space over here, and then there's nothing there.
Oh, you
there,
think the bleed
there.
Line?
Yeah. I
yeah, but look at how far the red line goes down. Like, it goes down to the corner, and it's not on the edge, is what I'm saying.
Maybe.
It's like,
but
looks like it would be cut.
And
there's
none
no,
up on the top, either.
But there's no green dash. On this top or this here.
I would say that's a red line.
Yeah, that's probably a miscut.
Okay.
Do you remember the orientation that it goes in?
I do. Any other questions?
No, I'm just curious.
Okay.
So if you can please displace... Josh, do you want to hit it back?
Yeah,
do you automatically hit it back?
It just says critical evade, knock back 2.
Okay. So you knock
1,
him back 2, and then
but he's just going to stop, right?
No, he's going to break that. So with the labyrinth...
I thought it was indestructible.
Oh, it is indestructible. Sorry. You're right. Primordials ignore this tile. So he can land on it.
He just stands on it. He stands on top of the maze.
And
then he's going to put more maze into the maze.
He's going to stand on top of the maze?
Yes.
Yep. But it's a wall. I don't understand.
He stands
it
on
says
it.
The primordial ignores those spaces.
Oh, okay.
It was hand-placed laser-cut tiles for the prototype, after all. He's just trying to get a running start. But guess what? That's the end of his turn.
I thought he did the whole thing about...
Oh, that's right. He sheds out tiles. So he is going to do... So on the bottom of that card, where the hell is it? It says Labyrinth 1. So Labyrinth 1, and it's important that I keep that break token there. Place one labyrinth tile adjacent to the primordial's rear. If placed on a titan, they gain a danger. But so it's going to be whatever token it was on. So you have to get another one of those zigzags, Anne. I'm going to let you decide which way it gets placed. You're going to be the primordial tile girl.
You're going to be the maze how his tile poop girl. Comes out.
Oh, that's fantastic. I've you're never the, felt you're much the poop handler. Myself.
So go ahead
is
and place it.
Is it zigzagged because he was shaking his butt as he pooped?
Adjacent
to his rear?
Adjacent to his rear.
I guess I could put it that way because that's still adjacent to him.
Yep.
Yeah.
And thank you for the follow, flowers.
I like flowers. I just threw that on the floor.
Aggressive.
B. Aggressive. And so then it rotates clockwise. So next time we're going to take the next piece.
How are the red lines on the other zigzags? That's what I was looking at as I was placing it, and it's exactly the same.
We're just going to play with it that way. We'll make it more difficult on ourselves, if anything. Okay, cool.
You know, actually, on this one, there's a faint hint of red line on the edge.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can see it.
On that.
I don't know
just
if you're
on
able
that
to see it
one.
On the camera. Yeah, you really can't see it on the camera. On this edge here is a very, very faint red line.
Yeah.
Okay, so it is now our turn.
Okay.
I'm pretty close to him, so I'm going to run... Am I adjacent at where I am?
You're adjacent.
I'm going to attack where I am right now.
Okay.
Because I might want to run into the maze.
So you're going to get a rage.
I am going to get a rage.
And you're going to get priority target token.
Yes, because I have the highest rage now. So it's whoever goes to the highest rage first. So everyone else that goes to one rage doesn't get the priority target token.
Right.
But if someone goes to two rage, the first person to go to two rage would get the priority target token.
He doesn't like your bad temper.
Yeah. So I'm rolling 3d10s to attack. To hit the monster is 7. I've got plus 0 on my weapon. So
why 3d10s?
Because my card is 3.
Ooh. Could you give me the priority target token?
So I rolled a 4, a 7, and an 8. So that's actually 2 hits. And the important thing there is that each of us has 1 red Kratos die for the base of our titans. And then I'm going to gain 1 red Kratos die for each hit. So I am going to have 3 red dice that I'm going to add. So I draw the top.
Seriously?
Yeah. 3 dice. So I draw the top body part card, and I'm going to need it because the top one is the eroded breastplate, and it is 3 on the ATO field. So I need to roll 3.
Breaks.
Breaks. Give me a break. Give me a break. I rolled 3 breaks. Hey, look at that. I rolled a 0 on 1, a 1 on 1, and a 2 on 1. Yay, go me. So wound, perform signature attack against the attacker.
What's the signature attack, Matt?
It's not great. So the signature for Mr. Bull is going to be charge. So it's going to automatically attack me. So go ahead and turn him to face me.
Yeah.
And then he is going to... he's going to trample, too. This is a nasty one. So I need to roll 2d10s, and I dodge on a 9+, because I've got one from my skirt. Skirt, skirt. It's a 7 and a 4, so that's 2 hits. Each hit is going to do 1 danger. So, Josh, if you could please up my danger by 2. And I need to draw a card.
That's a level 1, right?
I don't know. Yeah, it's a level 1. 1 through 3 is level 1.
Yeah, so you're in front of Twitch. Like, grid for you, but you're in front of Twitch. So Twitch is going to get trampled as well.
Yeah. Why did you... Okay, never mind.
Oh, now you're okay with it.
Yeah, because it's burst of speed, perform a free move. So that's an interrupt, right? So I can now move out of the way of his trample.
Yep.
Okay, so just scoot me one space to the side, please, Josh. Or Anne.
Are you bull skirting?
Yeah, I'm olaying.
Olé.
Olé. Oil of olé.
But what happens now on a Twitch?
Oh, they're going to get trampled. So thanks. I appreciate that. So now he's going to perform trample. Which is full move Labyrinthorus in a straight line. Every titan that it moves through suffers knockdown. Every knockdown titan it moves through immediately draws an obol. So go ahead and full move him forward in a straight line. 7 spaces.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
And they will be knocked down. So they'll get up again. You're never going to keep them down. But what that means is that on their next turn, right, Josh?
Yeah, the status, their condition deck.
Oh, the condition deck says it?
Yeah.
So knocked down, not knockout. Knocked down. You are knocked down. You cannot perform movement, activation, or attack, or other abilities unless otherwise stated. Discard this card at the end of your next turn. Stand up. All knocked down Titans with a knocked down card stand up at the start of the Titans' turn.
So they stand up at the end of your next turn. They haven't taken their turn yet. So yeah. They'll actually stand up right away.
Yeah, they'll stand up right away. Okay. So that one's not too bad then.
Discard this card at the end of your next turn.
So stand up, all knockdown titans without a knockdown card. Oh,
so it's
okay,
the turn
sorry.
After next. They're not going to stand up right away.
You have this knockdown card. Discard this card at the end of your next turn. So they'll discard this card at their next turn. Then the following turn is when they can actually stand up. So, gotcha.
Okay.
So I discarded the card now. I'm just saying they're skipping their turn.
Yep.
So because they can't do anything anyways. So discard the card. It's the end of their turn. Yeah.
They'll stand up.
Who's going next? Technically,
they don't stand up now.
Hold on.
They stand up at the start of the next turn.
Mm-hmm. I didn't move.
Nope, you didn't move.
So what was that?
And you also have back way one, and you didn't leave any of your tokens yet.
Yeah, and you have to do the Obel card.
The Obel is only if he runs over you when
you're knocked down.
When you're knocked down already.
Yeah.
Is that what it said?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I'll put it back up there. Trample is every Titan it moves through suffers knockdown. Every knockdown Titan it moves through immediately draws an Obel. So the first time it runs over you, you get knocked down. But then if he runs over you again while you're knocked down, you draw an Obel.
Yeah.
So I automatically leave an opening because of my Siren Teeth. And then I'm going to leave another opening.
Did you escalate the decks?
Not yet. So then I am going to escalate. That's that song by Nate Dogg, right?
That's it one. Escalators.
Do they have an animal cover?
Escalators, like the ones you go up.
Yeah, your quality of your jokes keeps on going down. Go ahead and shuffle that, please.
Why do you shuffle it under the table?
So that she can't be tempted to see what's a level 2 and a level 1.
Keep my shuffling honest.
All right. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, so that's the end of my... Well, no, I could
you
still
have back
move.
Away one, so you can move one space, and then you can move up to 5 spaces.
You're going to run in and tank it, right?
I'll try.
You have to be in range. Otherwise, it's going to attack Twitch and probably kill them.
Okay.
Also, you can't... Where you stand, you can't be in the trample zone. Like, you can't make it trample Twitch.
Okay.
You say that... So I'm going to go ahead and I am going to move basically one space adjacent to green.
Here?
Yeah. Thank you. All right. So you use guys' turn. Twitch can't do anything. Sorry.
And can you get over there?
What's the movement? Five?
One, two, three, four, five.
And I have reach two. Yeah, I can hit it.
You can?
Mm-hmm.
Where did it leave you?
It's taking up these four corners,
okay,
and
sorry.
I would be here.
It's a little
off-center,
so I thought it was one more space towards
reach
you.
Works a little funny in this game, so it has to be one, two, even though, like, so diagonal is two.
That's most games.
I kind of feel like reach two, diagonal, or whatever, like, I would think that this would be reach two, where you skip a space, but...
You'd be wrong.
What are you... Go away!
Stop. You're, like, on the line there, but... It wasn't centered within the four tiles, so that's why I was confused. So I was doing it so it's easier to see.
One, two, three, four, five. You can't get there, correct?
Nope.
Okay, and Twitch is done. So I'm the only person that can go. So you put two openings in. I'm going to hit with my spear.
Your sphere?
Sphere of influence.
So you're going to roll two d10s. You're going to hit. Right. So it's a 7 plus to hit. Hold on, don't roll yet. 7 plus to hit, plus 2 accuracy. It's 5 plus. There's two openings. It's 3 plus.
You can do it, Ann.
1 and a 2. 10 and a 6. So that's two hits and a chance for a critical.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because that's a perfect hit. Nice. So you are going to have one natural d10 from your character, from your Titan, and then two d10s because you red
Kratos
die. Red, one red from your Titan. And two red from your two weapon hits.
And my rage will go up to one because I'm attacking.
Correctamundo, senorita. So we're going to draw one body part card, and you're attacking his armored leg.
So I only need two to break the AT field.
That is correct. So two breaks. That's three breaks.
Three breaks.
Killer. All right. So that means because you wounded on a perfect hit, that is a critical. So the Labyrinthoros gains minus one movement. So
just real quick, he has an instinct here, which didn't really matter because there was no break tokens.
That's his instinct.
What?
You said instant.
Whatever.
There's an instinct there. So the instinct always happens?
Yes.
Okay. So that would remove all break tokens from the Kratos pool. But I didn't put those in there because I'm smart. And so, there you go. So reduces movement by one.
So he's at six movement.
You're
and also,
welcome.
Josh, reduces life total by one. And can you shuffle that, please?
Yep, but that was my first. Oh, it doesn't. That's doesn't matter because I hit twice, right?
You hit
because you got the extra die for hitting twice.
You get an extra red die.
Oh, okay.
So you only hit one location. It's just how good you are at hitting that location.
So good at it.
So good.
Okay.
Josh, you can move into tank.
He can't reach. Five spaces closer.
Yeah.
What was the ending? It just escalated and that was it? It didn't do anything in retaliation?
No, because when you critical, typically they don't retaliate.
How about them apples?
So, now Josh, remember what I was saying?
Yeah.
About not being in the way. And because his attack naturally attacks the furthest person in range.
Okay. Oh, you're going to I'm going to get trampled. You need to go, like, over here.
Yeah, I'll go, like...
You have priority token.
That's only for tiebreakers.
I know. So you need to be away from him and further away from him than Matt is.
No, because I'm out of range.
Are you out of range? Yeah, you're just out of range.
Because now he's at six?
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Planned it that way.
Just have me...
Thanks, Sam. Ow.
Have me... Come this way.
Where?
That way. This do way. It. Do it, wench.
Please, thank you.
Use your word. Where do you want me to go? One, two, three, four, five?
Yes. Thank you.
So exactly in still the same place for me to get trampled.
Where else can I go
just
for you not to get trampled?
Go run over that way.
I will not be in range. I can not come and you can get hit. And then he won't trample you.
It would probably attack Twitch then. Actually, it's probably still going to attack Twitch because they're farther than you are, but still in range. Do you get it?
No, I'm four away from him. There.
Yeah. One,
away.
Two, three. I like how he says no. And
I'm
then
four spaces away. They're three spaces away.
So you're still a little one space further.
Yes.
How are they three spaces away?
Ah! One, two, three, four. They're four.
He has to move 1, 2, 3 to get to me. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Save Twitch.
You good there, Josh?
I'm good.
I hope it hits you so hard. It's attacking the butthead with headbutt. No, it's attacking the closest Titan in front in range.
Why me?
There's no one in front of him.
In front in range? Okay, then what happens next?
Closest Titan in sight. That's you.
And then it turns. This is poopy.
That's no, it's okay. It's not gonna trample afterwards.
It's just gonna poop.
It's gonna poop. So Anne.
Yeah.
It's a one die, 9+. Do you have any evasion? You have a skirt, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
So that's an 8+ to dodge the attack.
I thought I had more.
Oh, each hit does 2 danger. That's nasty.
What?
And if you have 3 more fate, it's an extra 2 danger.
That's a nasty one. So 1d10. You rolled.
4.
I thought it was an 8, but okay.
Oh, yeah, an 8.
You want to re-roll it? That's 3. Okay, so that's a hit. So it's going to hit you for 2 danger.
Unless you want to spend the fate.
And re-roll it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll spend the fate.
Hey.
That's an 8.
Cool. Good roll.
Thanks.
I didn't have faith in you.
I know.
So it doesn't hit you.
She had faith in herself.
Yeah. But now he's going to labyrinth. So I mean he's going to poop. So Anne, put a straight tile adjacent to his rear. He laid a long log on that one.
How do you know it's a straight tile?
Because it's on this card. We're moving
it moves it?
Yeah. Every time you place one, it moves it to the next labyrinth
tile. What happens if it doesn't fit on the board?
Turn it sideways.
Oh, I guess.
God.
I just kind of assume that.
God,
it came straight out. No, it takes a hard left or right once it comes out. It actually comes out sideways.
Thank you, Joshua.
It prolapsed.
Thank you, Joshua.
Okay, and then that's going to rotate.
That's it?
Yep, it's our turn now.
Hey, that wasn't so bad.
So, Twitch should probably go right now so they could stand up, just in case of anything. I'd rather not have them get trampled.
Be a good thing.
So let's have Twitch go. They get up. They are fine, and they could actually do their turn. Oh, sorry. Back it up. Anne, what are you putting in the Kratos pool?
Oh, so I had one rage, and I can decide whether I want to leave a break or an opening. What do we think? We're going to have Twitch go next, so let's strategize it.
They can wound for days.
Oh.
They need opens.
They need openings.
Okay, so let's leave an opening.
Yeah. They can't get to the butt. Twitch can only attack from right in front of the butt.
Yep, in front of the bull.
The bull. I thought they said butt.
No, the bull.
I got butt on my mind.
Oh, so that, I think maybe that this is kind of important. We said about the priority token that the person that gets the priority token is the first person to get rage.
Twitch has blood on the hands. And that's going to be basically whenever you tie the leader for the rage, you get the priority target token. So the bull sees red. But then.
You know what else is kind of cool?
No, Anne, tell me.
I have the imprisonment.
Because every minute, like, with you as a person.
Hate you.
So when your danger is 3+, you may reduce knockbacks and pushbacks suffered by nodes.
Which is 1. I guess he's knocking down and not knocking back.
Yeah, knockdown is different.
Yeah, all right. It's just a thought. What about yours, Matt? Does your Mnemnos give you any special abilities for fight?
I don't have any nodes for it, so.
You should start with 1 node.
Oh, you start with 1 node?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. I didn't mark that off. Can I have a pencil? Thank you. So this is when I have 2+ danger. Once per battle, for one number of nodes per battle, I can gain a fate to discard one
condition
from a
condition card
or a tokenless condition card.
That's right.
So it's slightly helpful.
And Josh?
Mine is I can gain X fate, which is a one fate.
X fate, X is equal to number of nodes?
No, actually, sorry. X fate to add plus X to a die roll. The max of X, yeah, it's 1. I thought there was how many times I could do it. So, yeah, once per adventure, though.
Oh.
Is this an adventure? Or is this a battle? I don't think I could use this in a fight. I think this is only for, like...
adventuring around?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Twitch is going to run up and hit the bull in the face. Big disgrace. Waving their bull hands all over the place.
Okay.
We will.
3. So... Twitch has the big club. Oh, no, and they got the thing.
They have the shit shield. Or as Josh likes to say, the scat shield. exhaust the tree club. So, yeah, they're going to exhaust it. It is... Oh, yeah, their movement's only 4. Something else I forgot to mention. Because that thing's so big and heavy.
Where is the club?
They don't have the club. They have this.
They upgraded to the shield.
You weren't here for that. Sorry.
Okay.
So, they're going to exhaust it. They're going to roll 2d10s. It's going to hit on a 7+ naturally. They have +1 accuracy, so it's going to hit on a 6+, and there's a break, so it's going to hit on a 5+. So on a on 2 hits, it's going to double up what they're getting. So that's a horrible roll. They hit nothing.
They can spend 2 fate to reroll?
They can spend 2 fate to reroll. I would recommend that, especially since you're exhausting your card anyways. So that would be a really bad loss if you don't get to do that. So... chat, shout it out, just to make sure that that's what you want to do. What's their fate at anyways, Josh?
Shout.
0.
Shout.
Oh, so they can let it all out. Yeah.
They said reroll.
Reroll. All right, so we're going to spend 2 fate. So, Josh, have them...
It's updated.
Have them reroll 2 dice, but that's me. So what they need to hit is a 5+.
Yeah.
Not a 4 and a 1. How about a 10 and a 4?
That'll do.
That's 1 hit, but it's a chance for a critical. So, as a reminder, though, they're going to have 1 red from their Titan, 1 black from their weapon, and +1 break automatically.
That's cool.
That's pretty swanky. So, BP card, body part card. Ooh, they're attacking the underbelly seal. Make the noise for a seal.
What kind of a seal? seal. What's that?
But guess what?
Special seal.
Instinct. So do we attempt to wound first, or does his instinct happen?
Instinct happens.
Does it? I think that always happens.
Yeah, but does it happen before or after the wound
attempt? I thought you're supposed to read it from top to bottom.
Yeah, but does the wound attempt happen here and then it goes to that? I don't remember the exact order for it. I would assume...
What's the maze touched card?
It's a Nemos.
No, it's a condition card. Look at the icon.
Yeah, sorry. That's... I thought it was a Nemos.
No, but you get it. You gain one, a Nemos, if you crit. So if that's cool.
Oh, yeah, and they have a chance to crit here.
Knockdown, shaken, knockout, dread, bleed. It's got to be one of the other ones.
Josh, are you reading the book or are you staring at the monitor?
Everything. Staring at the monitor.
All right, so I'm going to say that they attempt to wound first, and he's just automatically going to do his instinct before the critical. Okay? I think that makes sense. So we're going to need them to roll a red and a black die, and they have one already. So they just need to roll one. One break.
Do you have other condition cards, Joshua?
Oh, so he's going to do that regardless if it's a critical wound or anything else.
Okay.
The only exception to this is a critical wound, which negates all instant responses. So actually, critical ignores it. But it happens on a fail or a success.
Or a wound. Hold on. So a critical ignores the instinct.
Yes.
That's actually really, really important.
Yeah, it is. So they rolled a break and a potential, but they only needed one because they automatically have one.
Yeah.
So they succeeded.
They succeeded.
On the critical.
On the critical.
Where are the Nemos cards?
Oh, my God. They're not going to gain a Nemos card. They're going to name a Nemos node.
They get a node.
Oh. I got excited.
So.
What are you writing down?
I thought that their sheet was over here. So what's their Nemos again, Ann?
No, you say it.
Blood on hands. So that's going to be... you gain the priority target token when your rage is equal or higher. What are the different...
They now have two nodes.
Just trigger the story event when you hit three. So they're one more closer to hitting that story event.
Oh, okay, cool. But then they're going to escalate. You're going to sing that song.
Yeah. So they're priority target now.
Yes, they do have the priority target token.
Escalators! Roll out!
No, that's not the song.
I can't do the blood one like you do.
Blood...
Sword song in Disney.
I can't wait to take Stephanie to the Magic Kingdom to see that.
She's never been to the Country Bear Jamboree?
I don't know. She hasn't been to Disney in many a year, she said. So guess what? We have a level 2 AI card coming up.
And a level 2 body part.
Yep. So now Twitch gets to decide what they want to leave in the Kratos pool. So do you want to leave an opening or a break? They've got one rage, right, Josh?
Yes, one rage.
Who's going to go next?
Well, let them figure out what they want to leave.
Well, shouldn't we discuss who's going to go next so that we can synergize with that 100% decision? 100%
wrong.
Cool.
You can sidestep him and poke him in the side.
Opening is best, right? It depends. Some people are better at hitting, and given that it's a level 2 body part card coming up next, the extra break might come in handy. It's a level 2 on top.
Yeah.
So I want to go next.
And you have plus 2 accuracy, so
break,
I think
level
break
2 break. They're all saying break.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so who's going next?
That'll be me.
Do you want to maybe sidestep it so that way...
I think that's an excellent idea.
In case, for whatever reason, he has like a reaction where he tramples.
Do you want to stand here, 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 or here?
Well, hold on. If she goes on the diagonal...
Yeah.
If the bull would rotate to face her for whatever reason, she would never be in the line of sight to trample.
Because he's got to move orthogonally.
Yes.
So a diagonal.
Where? I can't see.
Sneaky move, sis. Okay, so I'm going to roll for the spear.
What's your spear?
My spear is 2d10s plus 2 accuracy, and it'll give me 1 red die.
Per hit. So it's a 2, so it's a 7 natural, so it's going to be a 5 plus a hit.
Don't we need to know anything?
No.
That's a 10 and a 3.
Yeah.
So you...
One of them's poopy.
You're going to go for a critical here.
Lots of 10s tonight.
Yep.
Thank you for the follow.
Reinforced skull. 4 ATOs for this one. The ATO field.
Okay, so there's one break in the pool.
But if you wound, it ignores the instinct because you criticaled.
Oh, my lord.
Crit him. to break him easier.
I really wish it was two hits right now. Oh, can I reroll my? Can I take a fate to reroll that three?
You actually can.
Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm definitely going to try for that.
By the way, you have two rage now, so you have priority target.
Also, Anne, keep in mind that your second rage gives you a reroll of one of your Kratos die.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
That's a seven, so yes. That is another hit.
And I aggressively threw it across the board.
That is going to give you an additional Kratos die.
That's cool. Okay, I feel much better about this now.
So you've got three with one reroll to try and get four.
Yeah,
and
there
is a break
in the pool.
So you rolled. Wow, that was a shit roll.
Two blanks. That and the potential. So this will use the break in the thing. So I just need to come up with two breaks.
One die.
Off on ghoul.
So you need to roll a double break.
One in six chance.
One in six chance.
This could be really good or really bad.
Yeah. Oh, wow. That teased you. It was a break and a potential. So that is a failure.
Can't reroll Kratos dice with fate.
Yep.
It's only a D10.
Yep. So it's going to remove the break from the pool. Then you're going to fail. So he's going to escalate. Oh, he's escalating the AI card. Oh, geez. So he's going to escalate, and he's also going to... Oh, that.
How does he poop another tile out if there's already a tile there?
It's going to lay on top of it.
It's going to be a poop maze?
Yeah. He's stacking them. So it's the square, Anne. So go ahead and organize that however you want. It's Vosht. You tried so hard, Anne.
I did.
You got so far. But in the end...
It doesn't even matter.
I don't get it. What are you saying there? Anyways, I'm sorry. He's going to escalate, which is really, really nasty, because this is a level 2 body part card. So the level 2 body part card will go in the discard pile, because you failed.
Thanks.
And he is going to upgrade to a level 3
AI card
here. So, Anne, you get to shuffle this. There's only, like, four cards in the AI deck, so there's a pretty good chance that it's going to be up there when he, you know. Yeah, so he doesn't update the BP. I put the level 2 BP back in the discard pile.
Blood pressure?
Yep.
Yep.
All that pooping gives him a high blood pressure.
He's draining. All right, so who else still has to go?
Well, that was it? That was the end of the failure?
Yeah, that's it. It wasn't
what was the escalate after that? Because don't you do the failure and the escalate?
No.
That escalates only if you wound.
Oh, okay.
Matt, you can't get...
No, I can't get to him where he's at right now.
All right, so I'm gonna rush into his face, I guess.
So what's rushing, Josh?
Rush is a band.
No, Russian is a kind of dressing. It's like mayonnaise, ketchup, and pickle.
It's not chocolate, like people from Russia.
Rasputin.
No. But rush is an ability we all have, which is when you have 2+ danger. Which Josh, you have 2+ danger.
Yes, I do.
All right, so you're gonna spend a fate, gain a fate. And move at least 3 spaces up to a maximum of your 5+1, and you're going to gain a red Kratos die.
Are you going here?
Yep.
So, Josh, I'm just confirming that you want to rush because it's only a level 1 BP on the top.
Yeah, I want to rush.
Okay. I couldn't leave anything in the Kratos pool because my roll sucked.
You hit.
No, you hit. You still get to leave one. I'm sorry. You do.
Oh, I do?
It's not on wounds. It's
okay.
On hits.
Then leave a break.
You're leaving a break.
Yeah, right? That's what you need?
I would rather have an opening.
Yeah.
Oh, so fine, then leave an opening.
Especially if he's rushing.
If it's a level 1?
Yeah.
Yeah, because
breaks are better for damage. Openings are better for hitting. So if it's a level 1, it's probably not going to be too much to damage it, so you want to hit.
7+ to hit. He has one opening there, so it's a 6+. I have +1.
5+.
5+.
How many dice do you roll?
Just 1.
One.
That's how many dice he rolls.
Josh, you taking a fate to reroll?
Yeah, I'll take a fate to reroll.
That's a great idea.
Because you gotta have fate. That's a 2.
2.
You did better.
It's an improvement.
Okay. It doubled my last roll.
You did.
100% improvement.
Most improved award.
And can you move me into that labyrinth?
You want to be a little bit more specific?
The labyrinth that I am close to.
This one?
Yes.
Into it?
Yeah. Oh, Twitch should have that.
No, Anne should have that.
Does she have 3
Where
now?
Are you going?
She has 2 now. Twitch has 1.
Okay. The other opening. There you go. I'd like to be there. Thank you very much.
She can hide like a baby?
Yeah.
He is a baby.
Okay. Bold move, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off.
All right. It's the bull's turn.
Yeah. So what's going to happen is he's going to attack me, and he's going to trample all of you on the way.
Find out what happens.
Oh. Okay, so furthest Titan in front in range.
Oh, I just broke his tail.
Why is he going that way?
He goes the most dangerous path through everyone.
Why did you break his tail?
Because I don't like him.
Did he displace or does he trample?
He tramples and displaces.
No, he doesn't trample here.
Oh.
So he just moves. Trample is a special action after the fact.
Matt, are you considered...
in front?
Since you're
or in
the
sight.
Labyrinth.
Yes. There's a graphic in there, I think.
It doesn't say in sight. It just says in front, yeah. which is everything facing, essentially. So from the monster's tile forward in an endless line
yes,
to
this
either
way.
Side. Yeah.
There's a graphic in the book.
But yes, I would be
in the top.
So can you fix my character? I don't know. You just threw him off to the side and you just left it there.
Yep. That was your dodge. That picture.
I don't think it's that exact picture.
Whatever. It looked like that. I do think it is.
In front.
Guess which picture it is. What picture is it, Joshua?
Would you care to read aloud, Joshua?
No.
Matt had it correctly. Correct.
We both did because Anne said the exact same thing that I did. It's just that you think her opinion doesn't matter because she's a woman.
Rude. We're doing this again? 2 weeks and you didn't get it?
All right. So he's attacking me. It wasn't the trample action that moved him, so you're not going to take that knockdown. So that isn't quite as nasty as I thought.
Okay.
So you get displaced.
Okay.
So yay for that. I love that Metal God's using the rule 3. I love it. So he is going to attack me. It is 2 dice, 9 plus. I've got 1 evasion, so I need to roll an 8 plus.
Twitch would get displaced that way because actually, you're saying that they would get pushed?
Twitch would stay where they're at because he didn't end up... and
on top of them?
On top of them.
Okay.
Okay, so I rolled a 2 and a 7.
So the 7 hits.
They both hit.
Your 2 hits?
No. He's attacking me.
Oh, I misunderstood.
Yeah, so I'm going to take... each one is... each hit does 1 damage. If moved through at least 1 labyrinth tile, do 2 instead.
You didn't move through a labyrinth tile.
What does that... right, and the bull didn't move through a labyrinth tile. I don't know who it's referring to,
it's
but I...
it's talking
way.
About the bull.
Okay.
I like that it has the Hecaton's picture up on the top.
Yeah. Okay, so he's hitting me for 2. So I'm going to gain 2 danger. So, Josh, if you could up my danger by 2. I'm at 4, which is level 2.
All right.
Starting off strong here. Oh, who attacked last?
Me.
Did you leave?
No,
I
Josh
attacked
did.
Last. I'm at 1 rage. I would leave an opening.
Okay, thank you. I want to pick mine. Come on. Predict moves. Look at the top AI or BP cards. You may put it on the bottom or top of the deck.
Oh, that's nice.
So
you should look at that AI card that's a level 3 and make it go away.
It doesn't matter.
What do you mean it doesn't matter?
He's not going to do it now.
I don't understand.
Because he just went. So now we're going to go, and we're going to...
but it would be nice to know what that level 3 is when it does actually finally show up.
Minotaur logic. 1 die, 8 plus. Priority target in range. Each hit does 2 danger. Gain the alone faded Nemos card. Gain the fear card after hit. And then he labyrinths.
I want to get 7 fate just so I can be forever alone.
Forever Calzone.
Forever Calzone.
I'll move it to the bottom of the deck, I guess. So, then after hit, if moved through, at least 1 labyrinth tile, gain 2. That's not the case. After trauma, trample. So now he is going to run over me.
Yeah.
So he's going to full move forward in a straight line. That's not full moving forward in a straight line.
There you go.
That's not it. Josh!
Just kick,
I should not
just
have
kick him under the table next time.
All right, let's try this again. Up without touching the table, down. As you can see, the table is not needed to get out of your seat.
Okay. Matt, you're knocked down.
Yes, I am knocked down now.
But you'll get up again.
Exactly. And then he's going to labyrinth 1. So he's going to poop out another tile. So, Anne, it is an L. Can you please have him poop out an L? Give me an L.
A finger and a thumb.
Give me an S.
On the shape of an L.
On his brown eye.
Ew! All right, the board.
Wow, it really is always Josh's fault. Please don't have it land on me. Thank you.
Can't go backwards now.
Yep. I know. I think it's funny.
Okay.
What do you mean, okay?
Thanks, jerk. Okay. You also kind of blocked the blind spot of the bull.
Anyone to really attack him besides you. But okay.
It's fine.
That's how you want to play. Okay.
Well, hold on. Let me adjust the camera so that we can highlight kind of what Anne is doing here.
Hold on. It lined up with the hallway.
Hold on.
That's the only reason I put
there.
It there.
Now, if you look where the Kratos pool is on the main camera, that's how you're playing.
I don't get it.
Playing like ass.
That's so rude. That was good.
Please, so rude. Can you knock me down, please, Anne?
Yeah. So how do you want this to go?
No. You placed it. Wow, that's how you were thinking of doing it?
I have no idea.
Think about it, Anne.
Yeah. What if I just do that?
Oh, Lord.
Then you could go that way.
Sure.
You can't attack through the wall, though.
There's no way I can't block it. His
rotate
blind
it
spot.
90 degrees. Put it off to the right-hand side.
Off to the right-hand side? It has to be adjacent to his butt.
Right what? Side.
Only
He's got two rear tiles.
This way?
Right-hand side. Right
other side.
Hand side. Move it to the right. Move it to the right.
That's the right.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, my Lord. She did it, folks. It's a Christmas miracle.
I don't do well with directions.
Proud of you, Anne. Not really. I'm very
just
embarrassed.
Just stay there in the hallway and die.
Okay. So it's our turn now.
Yep.
So go ahead and attack it, Anne.
Okay. Joshua.
Yeah.
Are you able to move my mini up diagonally to them?
Where? I can't see.
Joshua.
There. What?
Okay. I'm going to roll my 2d10s.
You're at 3 rage now.
Sorry.
What?
The cat's hiding. Hold on. I guess I'll do it there. The cat's hiding.
Nobody see that. Is that guy over there dead?
D-E-D. He's knocked down. But he'll get up again.
Oh, Matt.
Did you roll a 10 and an 8?
I did.
That's really, really good.
And I was so careful because I couldn't see it over here to like place it down appropriately.
So that's 2 hits. You're hitting him in his armored leg.
Oh, with only 2. Man, this is so good.
Yep. So you're rolling how many dice, Anne?
3.
Why 3?
Because I'm going to get 1 red die for each of the hits. I hit twice. And I'm going to get a 3rd one because I'm special. Because you get 1 by default. And then I rolled 2, 3 breaks.
You only needed 2.
Yep.
Cool. So that is going to be a critical.
Yep.
So, Josh, reduce the Labyrinthoris's movement by 1. So he's down to 5 movement now.
He's getting crippled.
You're welcome.
It's like Stumpy.
It is like Stumpy.
I've chopped off 2 of its legs with my spear.
Just wait till you get to his 3rd leg.
I am really the matador here with my spear chasing the bull.
Not like the matador?
I don't get it.
Okay, so I'll do that.
And what tokens are you leaving? You get to leave 2 now.
Who
are
going
you?
Next?
Who?
I could make it to his butt.
Could you?
Yep.
Are you able to?
Yeah, if I rush.
Well, so then you need a break?
We don't know what's on the top of the deck.
Don't know what's on top of the deck yet.
I feel bad because I'm not I don't want to perpetuate bullfighting because I think it's animal cruelty.
No. Not if they eat the bull.
Torture it? No.
So they tenderize it, Anne.
Could Twitch rush to his butt? So Twitch does not have 2 dangers.
They also have -1 movement because of their weapon. Their weapon's heavy, so it's got -1 speed.
And their shield should be exhausted right now, and they need to unexhaust
it. Oh, that is very true, Josh. Ooh. So, Josh, you going to go rush the butt?
Well, tokens are Anne leaving.
What are you leaving, Anne?
Well, now you know that there's a level 2 on top, so you want...
The opening's good for him because he's only got 1 die.
Okay, so then we'll leave the opening.
2 openings?
What is Twitch?
Or
does,
1 of each.
Can Twitch get there?
No, they can't.
At all?
No.
So they're going to have to... Your best bet for your turn this time, then, is to unexhaust the card?
And get ready for next time.
All right. So do you need 2 openings? Because are you going to roll a 2 again?
We'll find out.
So should I just leave breaks? Because if he rolls a 2, he's going to waste the openings I put in the pool?
No, waste the breaks, too.
That's true.
What would you like to put in?
Let's leave 2 openings.
Okay. Go for it, Josh. So Josh is going to spend a fate in order to rush, then he's going to move an additional up to one space. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he's going to move 6 spaces there, be in the left cheek of the Primordial, and he is going to go ahead and roly-poly.
Can Twitch move 2 away from Anne and 2 left of Anne? 1, 2, 1, 2.
So remember, their left is your right.
Oh.
So they want to move 1, 2, 1, 2. So like adjacent to...
So how many spaces is that? 1, 2, 3, 4?
Yeah, they can move up to 4 spaces.
Yeah.
So Josh, you rolled.
An 8, so that's a hit.
That is a hit. So you're attacking the...
I get 4 Kratos dice, please.
Hydraulic pump.
Do we have any red paint? We can paint our shield.
All right. So it's a good thing you didn't leave any breaks in the pool hand.
Yeah.
Because the instinct
and
is
you didn't
that.
Do a crit.
Can you move this, please?
How many do you need?
4.
Okay.
And I have +1, so I need to roll 2 breaks.
Pretty good.
And I get 1 reroll.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a lot of breaks.
Yeah.
Just a few.
How many
5
breaks?
5 breaks. I get +1, so that's 6 breaks.
Cool.
Okay, cat bar.
So... that is going to be enough to wound. So he is going to Labyrinth 1. So he's pooping on you, Josh.
I hit him so hard he pooped.
So the Z has to go on his butt end.
Okay. So it's going to go like this.
Josh, please reduce the monster's life total by 1.
And it's going to go in your arm and crush it. Yay! Actually, maybe it should go like this. Yeah, that's fine.
Are you letting her make these decisions, Joshua?
As long as it's not on me, I don't care.
Call on me.
Nobody lets me make decisions.
You're right.
I get to back away, too.
Good for you. Did you want a cookie? Actually, some of that cake in the fridge sounds good about now.
No, it doesn't. So there's a level 3 AI card on the top and a level 3 BP card on the top. And I'm knocked down.
Yep.
I've only got taken 2.
So that means that I now get rid of the card that I would have received. So next turn, at the start of my turn, I get up.
Yep.
Josh, Twitch would like to move 4 spaces forward.
Forward.
There?
No, 1 back.
Am I directly behind the monster?
Yes, you are.
Yeah.
Ooh.
But the level 3 that you looked at was priority target token, which is Anne.
Yes, but... There's more level 3s in there now.
Is there?
Is it best for Twitch to be there or 1 over to the left? 1?
Definitely not 1 over to the left because then it would just trample everyone if it attacks you first.
If it attacks me first, it's not going to trample anybody. Because I'm right next to it. I don't understand.
He tramples after he moves.
But if it moves 1 south and then faces her, then it's fine.
I guess so.
I wouldn't make it move the other way.
So wouldn't Twitch go? Shouldn't Twitch go here in case it runs any? Would it run this way?
No,
I guess not.
Okay. So monster's turn. Oh, what are you leaving in the pool, Josh?
I will leave a
2 to the left was my hope, but the trample is a fear. True.
You're gonna leave 1 singular break.
Yeah, I only have 2 rage.
So I want to make sure that we're doing what Rakanos wants.
Yeah. So go ahead and move him into the spot.
But I'm a little confused, as you can see, about how well I did with putting the maze piece to the right.
It can't move 2 to the left because that's where the labyrinth is, and I'm kind of blocking their path. Oh, 1 back and 2 to the left.
So 1 back and here?
That's right.
Good. 1 back and here.
Hiding behind the maze.
Yeah. Wait. Which one?
Choice A or B.
Anne's first instinct or second instinct? First one.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So you were actually saying our left, so thank you.
Okay.
Okay, cool. So monster's turn.
Put up a bowl.
Bow to the labyrinth.
And I would like to not.
Okay. Closest Titan in front in range. That's no one. Closest Titan in sight.
That's me! Anne.
So... This is a magic. What's magic?
Oh.
Gain 2 danger and the dread card just automatically.
Yep.
That sucks. Okay. Give me the danger.
What's magic?
He does magic.
But then, like,
magic butt.
Also, Rarknos used the word y'alls, and it just makes me feel really good inside.
So then you're. But then how much damage do you take for. She still has to roll for the attack, though, no?
No, I think it's auto.
Then why is there a die at the top?
Because there's also a Hecaton up top.
Oh, you know why? Okay, I think I get it. It's not a move and attack. He does it from wherever he's facing.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a.
Ranged attack.
No. It's kind of like a. Intimidate. Excuse me. An intimidate in KDM.
So, and roll a die.
Rolling a die?
Yep.
Why? It's a 9 plus. An 8 plus. I rolled a 2.
Great roll.
Thanks.
Okay. So you take 2 damage.
You're going to gain 2 damage and the dread card. So, Anne, what's a dread card?
I don't know.
You want to look through your conditions?
Is it a condition card?
I don't know. Yeah, sure is. So, condition, gain minus 2 accuracy. You can only attack from the rear or weak spot. When you wound the primordial, discard this card and gain 2 accuracy. Battle aftermath. If you still have this card, draw the fated Nemos card.
And I get a trauma?
Yep.
And Argo loses something. And, of course, I get the bad one.
Yeah, because you stink. So you have thrown off balance. So exhaust all of your exhaustible gear. If no armor was exhausted by this card, then you're going to get knocked down. Do you have any exhaustible gear in?
No.
You're going to get knocked down.
Fun. Josh, can you knock my mini down? So what's interesting is the Argo loses one what?
Crew.
Yep. So he killed someone on the crew.
Jesus. Okay. And our crew was at 4, so now our crew is at 3.
That was really nasty.
Yeah, wait. Go put that back. So.
Why?
Oh, it's 8 plus fate.
Yeah, you don't have 8 plus fate.
Okay.
You're not that cool.
I have to get rid of this card.
Yeah.
I wonder what the fated Nemos card does.
Where's the trauma card?
66 clams!
No! 66 clams! He looked at you so scarily that one of the clam men committed suicide.
Clammed up! I'll see myself.
No, that was a good one.
That was
a good
one.
That was a good one.
That should definitely be a pun count.
yeah. I guess they didn't have the muscle for it.
No.
No.
I was kidding. This is terrible. Well then.
Yeah. Okay. So that's the end of the monster's turn.
I'm not enjoying this whole knockdown thing.
It's our turn now. So
I can't do anything.
You would get rid of that card now. So at the beginning of your next turn, you would be able to stand up. Yeah. I can stand up now.
Yep.
I'm not going to do anything yet. No, not yet.
Okay.
Don't push the table. So Josh, you should go next.
What's on top of level 3?
Yeah, you should go next. You're the tank.
What the one break? Okay, I'm going to rush.
Is it because today's Tom Sawyer?
YYZ.
You going in the blind spot, or?
I'm going to go on the side. I feel like blind spot doesn't give me a bonus, right?
And if I was to rush, could I reach the bull's blind spot?
What would rush give you?
6 movement.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes.
And you sound just like Josh. It's really weird.
Remember? It's Joshua! He asked me a question!
So you're running into the side?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, I can't. Yeah, I can because I can just go and run down. Yeah.
I'm going to get you a girdle to wear.
Why are you so adamant about shoving the table around?
So did you rush, Josh?
Yes, I rushed.
Okay.
What am I hit at, Matt?
The table.
Nothing. It's what the gaze of Temenos! End the attack. The Titan must pass resistance 8, or they gain 3 damage, 3 fate, and the dread card.
Oh my god! It's a good thing you went first. Resistance, what is a resistance 8?
Resistance is one of the skill checks that we have.
Oh, it's one of the permanent skills.
Yeah.
No, it's not. Endurance, courage, cunning, survival, will, and wisdom. So is it related to one of those 5, 6?
Do you use the right deck? It's a BP card.
And it's got the bull on it.
Just roll above an 8.
That's a 4.
Josh is going to spend a fate.
Yeah. This is bad. It's real bad.
Especially because if he fails again, he's going to go up to 9 fate.
Yep.
Isn't that when you have to start drawing Obel cards? Oh. He got 10!
Yes!
The card moves. Shoof the. Shoof. Shoof. Oh, I can't see it now. Doesn't matter.
Do it!
Good job. And go ahead and shuffle that. So that's in the deck, by the way, now. The deck of like 6 cards.
I don't want that one anymore.
Yeah, that's. Ouch, skibibbles.
Yeah. I'm at 3 rage, so I'm going to leave.
I kind of do want to know if that check.
Can you leave 2 openings, Josh?
Yeah, I can leave 2 openings.
Uses one of the skills, since we have a couple that are plus.
So, Anne, I'm going to stand back up because it's the beginning of my turn.
Yeah.
I am going to gain a fate.
Wait.
So I can rush.
I'm going to do this in slow motion.
Oh, I'm sorry. I can't actually rush because I only have 1 damage.
Danger?
Don't 1 danger. I missed the beginning. What level? It's a level 1. Labyrinthoros.
It's so much easier to spell that word than to say it.
Yes.
Matt, I have you at 4 danger. You've got hit a bunch.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was looking at rage. I apologize.
You're Telebacchus.
Yes.
The party god.
Yeah.
The telepathic party god. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Cool. Do you get a bonus for attacking in the blind spot?
I don't
think
so.
No bonus.
I think it's very Cadium, right?
Yeah.
Dice, please. I need the 3D10.
I wanted to see you use the force.
I don't know where the other one went.
No way.
Oh, my God.
There's like 800 D10s. How do you not hear?
Thank you for handing it to me. Okay. So. Okay, so it's cheese. I have no plus accuracy, but Josh said he was going to put 2 openings, right?
Yep.
Okay. So that means I'm going to hit on a 5+.
And you're at 2 rage now.
All right. So I rolled a 7, 8, and 2. So I'm attacking the plated beast head. And in a completely unnecessary display of strength, I am going to roll 4 red dice. Because I hit on 2 for my weapon, I've got 1 natural, and I rushed. And I rolled 3. Respectable. But enough to wound. So I am going to gain 1 fate, and he's going to perform his signature against me. Awesome. So these will go away.
This signature steak sauce?
Yeah, A1. So his signature is charge. So I'll escalate that in a second. He is going to target me, and it's going to be 2d10s, 9+ to hit. So, Anne, if you could turn him around, or Josh, one of the 2 of you. I rolled a 9 and a 2, so actually I did dodge 1 of them.
I'd just like to point out how I'm still not touching the table. Good, great, wonderful.
So I am going to take 1 damage, so 1 danger, Josh.
Okay.
Which means
5.
Yeah, I'm going to take another thing. And then he's going to trample me. But first I'm going to gain a trauma.
Hey!
Level 2 trauma, right?
Yeah, level 2 trauma.
I'm not getting trampled. I'm okay with this. Which is really great because I'm knocked down and I really did not want to get trampled.
The nice thing, though, is he's going to run and get himself in prime position for Twitch to beat him up.
That'll be great. I'm not touching it.
Though that could be that trap card again.
Rakano said that the same thing you did at the same time.
Oh, his trample gets him to Twitch. Yep. So I gained Dread. Gained the Dread card. I'm okay with this.
Everybody's got Dread.
Yeah. Okay, so.
It's dreadful.
It's dreadful. Absolutely dreadful. But I did do a damage. So, Josh, if you could please reduce the monster's life total by 1.
Okay.
He's going to escalate. He's going to escalate this also.
Twitch will save
you.
You
have 5 damage, right?
What?
You have 5 damage, correct?
How did he go from 7 to 8 before?
What?
I was watching the blood counter, and that definitely went from 7 to 8.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So he should be at 4.
I think maybe you went up once instead of down once. That makes sense. That's why it went from 7 to 8.
That would be a delta of 2.
Yeah, it would be.
Whatever. We're fine. We're good, folks.
It'll be fine.
Okay. So there is a level 2 BP on the top. There's a level 3 AI card on the top. He tramples. So Josh, or Anne, if you could move him forward 5 spaces. That's a really nice stand.
One, two, three, four, five.
And I'm going to be knocked down.
Sure are.
Now, Anne, if it trampled over you...
I'd be dead.
You would have died.
Well, I wouldn't have died. I'd have drawn a noble card. And that means I have a 50-50 shot of dying.
Which, you know what that would have meant, right?
I would have died.
No. You could have taken your skirt off.
This is not... Okay, yes, that's true. But that's so terrible.
You decided that was not a trauma card because it's a trauma.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so Twitch. Obel isn't trauma. Yeah.
But it's a funny joke.
So you want to move Twitch over to have him beat him up? Oh, I didn't say what I'm leaving in the deck. So I only have two rage. Jeez.
Blind spot. Twitch wants to go into the blind spot. So does Twitch... Does Twitch have two... No, still only one danger. What's the BP? It's a level 2.
Yeah, I'm going to leave two openings just because they get a red, a black, and a plus one break automatically.
Do you want to back the camera up a bit?
No. Why would I want to back the camera up?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to figure out how it would be nice to kind of see. You want to push that over there maybe so that they can see the BP and the AI cards?
No. I'll do it though if you want me to. Perfect. Great move, Anne. That was a real great decision. I'm proud of you.
I tried.
Okay. So, one each maybe. We only roll one to hit, right? Or was it two? You do roll two to hit. You've got plus one accuracy.
Here you go.
So, the thing is that if you were to hit twice, it would be way more beneficial than just putting another break in the pool.
Yeah.
Because you'd get a black die plus one. Or do you get just the dice?
No, you get black die plus one. So you get two breaks.
Two right away. Yeah.
Two openings is good.
Okay. So they're attacking. They're going to roll two d10s. That gets exhausted. And they're going to hit. It's a 7+. They've got one accuracy. So it's a 6+. Two openings means it is a 4+.
Ty was so nice. I said please.
Excuse me?
Ty was so nice. I said please. Ty. I'm sorry. My glasses.
Ty the Heartless says please. Oh, please.
6-6.
Six and six?
Yep.
Hey, that's two hits. So they're hitting twice. I'm going to move this closer. Thanks. So they're going to get one red die, two black die, two breaks. And they're attacking the servo motors.
What's that?
What? A servo motor? It's a motor.
Is that special? Tal. With an L.
Ah, Tal.
Thank you. Sorry.
Tal the Heartless.
Now I'll know forever.
Too bad they didn't crit. Maze Maze sounds interesting. But they are going to roll. So they're going to roll one red, two blacks. So they have two natural breaks. So they only need two.
Yep. Maze Maze is the bull's leg.
Can we re-roll? They want to know if they can re-roll.
Technically, yes.
You wouldn't be able to re-roll after you saw the card.
Oh, yeah, that's true. What a hell of a roll. Jesus.
All the breaks.
So they rolled seven. Okay.
They roll two black die because of that?
Yeah, because their weapons, they roll two black dice.
And they roll the best of the black dice that they
roll.
Yeah,
they did.
That's crazy.
That was a hell of a hit. So they're going to gain... Oh, this is bad. Okay, so they are going to gain a fate. So, Josh, if you can increase their fate by one.
It's fine. That puts their fate at three.
Now he's going to labyrinth. It's a straight piece. Okay, this actually works.
Yeah.
Because you could make it come out of the left butt cheek.
I could do whatever I want to do.
That's
I can
true.
Do.
You could also do it sideways.
Anything. What do you mean you're supposed to do it sideways?
You could also do it sideways.
So that I would crush Twitch?
You can do it so just the one space is on there. You see?
I don't like that.
Okay.
I would have done the same thing Anne did.
Remember in the game we play where you don't get a plank to make a bridge? There's your little bridge. I made a bridge. See? Now... Okay. You can get over it.
So he doesn't have very many AI cards left. And the ones that he does have left, they're all basically level 3s.
It's funny.
He'll be so upset.
He said, okay. I said, it's funny. Okay.
Did you do some monster life total by one, Josh?
I'll do that now.
Cool. Who else still has to go?
Me. No, I'm down. Just kidding.
Josh went. Twitch just went. It's the end of everything.
Yeah, it's monster's turn.
Monster is going to go now.
So what tokens are they going to leave? They only leave one token.
Yeah.
They're only at two rage.
So what token would you find folks like to leave? There's a level 2 BP on the top.
You both have dread.
Yeah. Openings would be really nice here.
Yeah. I'm not good hitting, so opening.
Opening.
Yeah.
Opening. Okay. So opening's going to go in the pool. The ass pool.
It's mine.
Ass. All right. So monster's going to go. What in the hell is this?
Oh. What is it? Show it to the world.
Oh, my Lord. That's nasty.
What?
Home run. It's going to attack the closest Titan.
Oh, Twitch.
Move unlimited and attack. Each hit does one damage. After trauma, he's going to labyrinth one, and then he immediately performs another attack to the next closest Titan, not yet targeted, up to three times.
So he's going to hit all of us.
Yes.
And you and I are going to get an Obel card.
No.
Why?
Because he is not trampling. He's just moving. The trample is a special subtext.
Oh, okay.
Which is, it's not as bad, but yeah, that's awful. So he's going to be shitting out a maze all over the place. So we're going to take damage from getting the maze shit out on us, probably.
Well, and we still have to roll for the damage, which is still the three dice.
Oh, yeah. It's not nice. So first he's attacking Twitch. They've got one evasion. So they are going to roll three d10s, and it's going to dodge on an 8+ because they have their skirt on.
This is a...
That is a nasty card.
I feel like he's moving forward by the pooping.
Yeah.
It's projectile.
4-2-2. Yeah.
It's like Nyan Cat, but with bull and poop. So that's three hits. So they're going to take three damage.
Okay. So that puts them at four damage.
So that means they're going to draw a card.
Well, what level card are they drawing?
It's going to be level two. And would you like to draw for Twitch?
No, I'll let Josh do it. That way he can take.
Take these broken wings and learn to fly again?
Yeah. Now we have all touched it.
Okay, cool. They're going to gain two rage. You got a good one.
Not bad.
Yeah. So they, what's their rage at now, Josh?
Four.
So next time they attack, they're going to be in a pretty good spot. It's going to be a while before they can attack, but you know. So now he's going to labyrinth one. So Anne,
yeah.
While you drop stuff, we need the square labyrinth token.
Okay, hold on.
What happens when we run out of labyrinth tokens?
That is a great question, Josh, and I'm glad you asked.
Why?
I don't know.
Square labyrinth token. He's pooping it here.
Oh, that's true. You can F him up with the fists. All right. So you put that out. Now he is going to attack the next closest Titan, not yet targeted by this attack.
So he's going to move too forward. These are going to get the place.
Displaced.
Displaced.
One, two. That's not really where Matt is.
So I need to roll 3d10s.
Yep.
And it's going to hit me on an 8+. Three hits. One damage each. It's going to put me up to 8 danger. I need a level 3 card, please, Josh.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Here, I'll do it.
He has to do a silly shuffle first.
What? Because this is magic trick. Draw a card and don't show it to me.
Oh, Lord.
Just kidding. Show it to me.
Out cold. Knock back 6. Gain the knockout card.
What if you already are knocked out?
No,
it's
I'm knocked
down.
Down.
Oh. Knock back 6?
Yes.
So the board edge.
So wasn't there something about hitting the board edge?
Knock out the board edge, is you cannot stand up. You cannot perform actions or other abilities unless otherwise stated. Come to. You may perform an endurance 8+ test. Excuse me, to regain consciousness once per turn. If you succeed, stand up and discard this card. During the battle, you can knock me knocked down or knocked out again. So adjacent Titan can spend a movement and an activation to help me up?
Yep.
Okay.
And endurance is one of the 6 skills. I happen to have a +1 in endurance.
I do as well. So that means that I'm going to be knocked down for a more extended period of time, which means leaves me more vulnerable to getting killed by trample.
Sucks to be you.
Does. Okay. So if you could put that back.
Here you go.
Thanks.
He's going to take a step forward. He's going to displace Twitch again.
Thanks.
Oh, no. He's going to poop first.
Yep. He is going to poop.
What shape?
an L.
This way is blocked off. No. Okay. There you go.
And he's going to sidestep one.
To me.
Yep. Great. All right. So he's attacking you now, Anne. So 3d10s hits you on an 8 plus. That's, you rolled a 10, so it's two hits.
That's not bad.
So 2 damage.
And what does that put you at?
4.
So that is a level 2 now, which is where disembowel is, Anne.
No, I think disembowel is a level 1.
No, it's level 2.
Is it? Are you sure?
And it's also a level 3.
I like option B. Good choice, Anne.
So the very first time I played this game, I pulled the disembowel card twice, and I don't like
that. That would be a third.
You just take the skirt off.
Don't look.
Keep your intestines in.
That man makes sense.
You know what? You're okay.
I can't get dread again.
There you go.
I'm okay with this. No, the next one.
Okay, so now he's going to poop again. It's the Z-shaped poop.
Okay. That looks good right there. Okay, great.
That's a big turd pile there.
He has a lot of fiber in his diet.
One forward, and he's going to displace you to the side.
Okay, and then he's going to murder you.
I need 3 dice.
What do you say?
Please. Now.
This is not what you say.
I have 2 evasion, so it's going to hit me on a get a dodge on a 7 plus.
Titans equal fiber.
That's a 10. A 2.
Okay, so 2.
2. Okay, I got 2 hits, so I'm going to take
2 damage.
2 damage.
What?
I was checking my fate. I am not at 7 plus. I am at 6.
I thought you were at 8. Oh, that was if you got damaged by the other
thing. I would be at 9 if I got damaged by the other thing.
That's right.
I did do a critical evade, so I get to knock back 2 to the monster.
Cool. So knock him back 2, Anne.
I thought that you had to roll... Oh, no, maybe not. Maybe that was the conversation we had last time.
And then...
I have to take a level 2 trauma.
He is going to Labyrinth 1. So, Anne, if you can please have him crap out a straight line. We're officially out of straight line pieces.
And zigzag pieces.
This is just a bad way to go.
Disemboweled! You die.
I didn't pull it this time!
It's okay. Josh is taking his skirt off.
Yep.
Ew.
I shoved it into my belly to hold everything together.
There you go.
That's the worst card ever.
Yeah. Yay! I like how Trouser Snacks is like, yay, skirt's off. All right, so that's finally the end of that atrocious card. It's our turn now. So I stand back up. No, I don't, because I'm knocked out.
Yeah, but I do. What are you doing?
My endurance check.
Why are you going first?
Because it doesn't really matter.
What if somebody was going to use their turn?
They need to use their movement and their activation.
Hey, I
no
stand
one can
up.
Get next to them, so.
Wait.
I stand up.
Do you stand up?
Yes.
Or do you still have to do something for knockback?
Nope. So I'm going to run up into his face now.
You have dread, don't you?
Yes.
You can only attack from the blind spot.
That's right.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Okay. So there was something with the blind spot there. Move me back in. Bacon. I will sidestep to the left one, please, Anne.
This way?
My left, sorry. There you go. The left my character was facing. that'll end my turn. I know, lame turn, but whatever. Who wants to go next?
Twitch can punch it.
Or Anne can stand up so she doesn't get trampled accidentally.
Yeah, I'm going to cut you guys.
Well, also, Anne's accuracy is pretty good, so she can go
but
now.
But I still have minus 2.
Oh,
she needs
that's,
attack
true.
From the blind spot.
That's true.
However, I have... What do I have? I have 4 danger, which means I can rush.
You can't get to his butt, though.
Why?
Twitch is in the way.
Well, she can't attack from the butt anyway.
Is this from
there.
Behind? The
nope.
blind spot?
Nope.
It specifically has to be here.
Yes.
And there's walls there, so...
You can't even attack.
Attack.
So, Anne, if you want to stay face down, you can have Twitch go and punch it, and then maybe have him move forward by a reaction or something.
Or I get trampled. Can we punch his butt from the maze?
No, punch him on the side, though.
Unfortunately, the maze has... red line.
Which are walls.
Here.
Yeah. What are you doing, Anne? You just end your turn, too.
No, I'm going to risk it for the biscuit.
Okay. So Twitch is going to punch him from where they're at, and then they can back up and
they
run away.
Run and hide?
I saw more people saying punching.
Sounds like punching from the side is the thing.
Okay. So we're going to punch. So that means that you're going to use your fists, which is going to be 2d10s. There is one opening in play. So that's going to hit on a 7+, naturally. It's going to be a 6+ because of that one opening.
They're at 5 rage. They get an extra red die, don't they?
Are they at 5 rage? Then
yep.
Yes, they'll get an extra
and
red
they have party target
Kratos die. They rolled a 4 and a 3. Those are 2 misses.
Unless they want to spend fate to reroll, though.
Unless they want to spend fate to reroll. What's their fate at, Josh?
3.
So, chat, do you all want to spend 2 fates to reroll your 2 dice? I see your reroll. So, I'm going to take that. More rerolls.
What?
It's a level 2 BP. So, a bunch of rerolls. We're going to have them roll 2 more d10s, up their fate by 2. Again, they need a 6+. So, 50-50. So if the first 2 were failures, then what's the probability that these 2 will be successes?
It's too many numbers. I don't do numbers.
50-50.
Yeah. It's independent.
50-50.
It's a 1 and a 5. That's 2 misses.
Well then.
They can move now.
They can move. Have them go step back and do something. Wow, I suck.
Where do you want to move to?
You know what the best part is too, Anne? They didn't unexhaust their weapon.
They said run and hide, so run behind
them. 1, 2, 3. Why not just behind the wall? Will they ignore the walls?
The bull ignores the walls, but he can't see in his blind spot.
1, 2, 3, 4.
That's not his blind spot.
Go into the maze.
Into the maze?
Yes.
Get in front, Matador style.
Hide behind Anne.
That's not a great idea. I don't make a great meat shield.
If they go here and he does turn around for some reason, that would open up the butt for you guys who have dread.
That is very true. Into the maze. Trouser Snacks said into the maze.
Into the maze.
And I like the name Trouser Snacks.
1, 2, 3.
You want to take that token with you?
Do you want to stand up and move the pieces?
No, you're
then
closer.
Shush your mouth.
No, you're rude. All right, so.
So, Josh, what are you going to do?
What tokens is Twitch leave it? Oh, they didn't hit.
They did not hit, so they do not get to leave any tokens.
So look, we didn't mention something in this stream that I had promised Twitch last show.
Nothing, because you weren't here last show. All right, so...
The show before last. I have... So Josh got his really cool toga costume, and then we were talking 2 shows again, and we're like, oh, Anne'll do the toga costume. So we have a store... Put in the store link.
It's not a store link.
Bits and bobs. I lost track of time.
And Josh and I were talking. So for $10 tip, he'll go put on a toga.
Get on with it.
For
you'll
20,
put on a toga.
I'll put on my toga.
I thought you were going first.
No, you're
this
first.
Time.
No. What do you mean no? No, no, no.
Yeah.
And then for $30, we're going to make Matt get in a toga. That's all I got.
And I thought it was $40. That mean you switched togas.
Yeah, we could do that too. Why do you look so dejected?
Because that took way longer to explain than it should have.
I thought you could do it, but you didn't.
Because I didn't know what cockamamie scheme you had thought up.
Great.
I'm gonna rush in a. Do I want to rush?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I'm gonna rush. I'm risking
do it,
for the
you
biscuit.
Pansy.
Got a 7 fate. And can you run me to the side of the bowl, please?
But you haven't seen Josh in my toga. To the side of the bowl?
Yeah.
Here?
Guys, I'm trying to do it on the Stream Elements Store, but I'm having issues. It's not on the Stream Elements Store, right?
The costume time is.
That's not the toga thing, though.
It would be the costume time, though, wouldn't it?
But that's not a tip. That's just the
salt
thing.
Yeah, so there was really no reason to put the Stream Elements Store link. That was a waste of everyone's time. So it's just a...
That was incredibly rude.
Ow. It's just a tip or a bits.
How do you do that?
I have no idea.
Tips can go through Stream... It can still go through Stream Elements, just not the Stream Elements Store. It's just in Stream Elements. And then bits is just through Twitch.
Your waste of time was appreciated.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm going to hit on a 6+ because I have +1 to my roll.
Yeah.
How'd you spend a fate?
What's your roll there, Josh?
A 1.
Okay. La Hue Zaher.
You didn't want to re-roll the same one?
What did I tell you during yesterday's stream, Josh?
Left hand.
But you rolled a 1 already, yeah. So it doesn't count.
What did you tell him yesterday?
You got to use your other hand. He was rolling abysmally yesterday.
Yes.
Yeah, that was another one. Yep. That was, yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Okay.
Then you want to stand up now?
Yeah, I think I'm going.
She is standing up.
Okay.
She can't attack, though.
No.
You can move.
Do I want to, though? No, I don't think so. Because if he's going to attack Matt...
Why do you think he's going to attack me?
Because you're the furthest in front.
Hope it attacks you with that attitude. All right, so end of your turn?
Yeah, it's the end of my turn.
So, he is going to encasin. Priority target. It's you, Ann.
No.
Oh, it's not? It's Twitch? Oh, okay. In range in sight. Nope. Closest Titan in range in sight. That's going to be...
Jersh.
Josh.
Yeah.
Wait, is it?
Yeah.
No, I actually think that it's me.
How are you closer than Josh?
Because
I'm adjacent to him.
Oh, I'm in front. I'm not in the sight. Never mind. Yeah, okay.
All right. So he is going to move and attack. Josh, roll 2d10s.
With your left hand. I hope you roll 2 ones. I really do.
9 and a 7.
Yeah, fine.
That's 2 dodges.
2 dodges.
You're fine.
Why does it have the hecaton
symbol?
All
the cards do.
So the other thing here is each hit does 1 danger. For each danger dealt, Labyrinth 1 in front of the Labyrinthoris. So he does nothing. Mm-hmm. But then, after attack, he is going to... Do you have 5 plus fate, Josh?
Oh, yeah.
He's going to perform his signature against you.
Since I did a full evade, does he still do the after attack?
It says after attack, not after damage.
Okay.
So, Josh, his signature is 2d10s, 10 plus.
So 9 plus.
Yep.
2 to 5.
So you're going to take 1 damage for each.
All right.
So now he's going to trample. By the way, he should be facing Josh.
He gains 2 danger?
Yes.
This does not help me either, this position.
It does.
Because
I'd
forward.
Have to go in here.
He's going to trample. He's going to run forward in a straight line. Hold on. Let Josh take a trauma first, because this is an interrupt.
I have 6.
You can't get rid of this one.
Can't.
It's a good thing you've got utmost willpower.
Yeah.
Discard up to 2 combat cards.
Condition cards.
Combat condition cards. If you don't have any, subtract a fate.
Yeah.
That's good.
But 7 fate now.
All right. Insight starts from the spaces in front of the primordial. No, that's...
In front?
That's in front. Insight is any spaces
except for the back,
I thought.
Page 21, according to the Kickstarter posted rulebook.
Yeah. Theme appropriate.
Toga, plus an extra $5 for all the nip slips last week. Smiley face, smiley face.
Who would have thought we ever would have made money off of Josh's nip slips?
What did you do? That's for
not
you.
Not last week, but
it
like
was the week before.
The week before, when I wore the toga.
Is when he was slinging pepperoni.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah, it's right there. Open it on a minute. Let's finish this up.
Okay. Why am I still holding that?
Okay, so he's going to full move forward in a straight line, trample Josh. So Josh is going to get knocked down, but he'll get up again.
Does he stay here? Yeah,
yep.
Because yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's the wall.
So also, Josh had 3 plus fate, so he's going to labyrinth 1. So he's going to leave a square labyrinth poop.
No!
Put it right here.
Oh, because I guess I could do it this way? Or must it be this way?
No. Why would you think it must be that way?
Because he's got 2 spaces behind him and there's...
Creepshow is now following. Thank you for the follow.
Thank you.
Oh, that was such a good video clip. Yeah, we have some fun ones.
The nips?
Yeah, we have some good nips.
Oh!
These nips.
Video nips.
I was talking to a friend about the Proclaimer one. I have to find it.
I mean, if you tip $100, you see my nips.
Oh, God, you don't.
In one of the videos.
Don't market it like that. Please never market it like that.
Don't trap us. I'm not. Oh, they're trapped. Oh, yeah.
There you go.
You're good.
Shelly.
Who's Shelly?
You.
I don't get it.
Okay, so. TOS raising. Josh, go change.
Yeah, I'm done, right?
Yeah. I think everyone's gone now, no? Or was I thinking of last turn?
You're thinking of last
turn. Yeah, I was. So, and you can actually go in and hit it in the butt now, potentially, if you want.
Does Twitch want to go? They can. I can. You're absolutely correct. But there's nothing in the Kratos pool, and I need openings.
So, yeah, here's the thing. I'm just going to interrupt you here for a second. And
Twitch should unexhaust.
They could either unexhaust, or they can spend their fate to rush, get the extra movement to run to the side of the bull and potentially hit them with their fists to leave openings for you.
Move three away from man. Real Ann, not Titan Ann. I took a shower. I don't
it's
smell.
It's not Titan Ann. It's Tight Ann. Like space Ann.
All right. I'll take it. Yeah. No. Yeah.
Why does he have to get changed right in front of us?
Because he's giving you a show. I can't even... You could have taken...
Yeah, and he's going to fall. He's going to fall and break something.
Unexhaust. They would like to unexhaust. Okay. Matt's plan is good. Unexhaust, but I want the weapon back.
Okay. They're unexhausting.
I vote with Tal.
The weapon. And then I don't know where they want to move to. Wait. Was that a $15 tip or a $1.50 tip?
That was a $15 tip.
Yeah, because we don't have alerts go off unless it's at least $5.
Yep. It was 10 to get Josh in a toga.
Yeah.
5, and then 5 more, I'll get in the toga.
Yeah.
15 more, and you're getting in a toga too.
Awesome. And then at that point, we'll almost have another giveaway.
Oh, that's exciting!
So.
Yeah.
Do they want to move out of the maze, the labyrinth? Can you fix their piece? It's kind of like
unexhaust,
right,
and then go play in the maze. Which piece?
Them. They're like kind of on the wall.
Oh, are they in the maze? No.
Yeah.
They're
in the maze. They moved in the maze.
So you'll.
Matt. So no, I don't want to.
Yes. Yes, you do. Yes. It's been a while since you've been in a costume.
It's been a while. All right. So they can just stay in the maze there.
Well, do they want to go play in the maze?
That's where they're at. They're playing in the maze.
Well, that's standing in the maze. Standing is not a game. You really are an only child. Is that what your parents told you? Go stand in the corner instead of go play with your sister?
Do we have a ball of endless string?
Maybe.
No, we don't. You have candy corn.
It's disgusting.
Candy corn is delicious.
I know. You're so strange.
What are you doing? Are you showing some leg? Disturbing. All right. So, Anne, go ahead and hit it.
You don't want to go?
I can't get to it. That's not anywhere close to 5 spaces.
Okay. I have how much danger? 4. So I can rush.
Yeah.
I'm going to gain a fate.
Yeah.
But I'll gain...
You don't get any accuracy.
No, but I'll green a thing.
Yeah.
A red die. Okay, so then I'm going to rush.
Do it, you pansy.
1, 2, 3.
Rushy, rushy, rushy.
I lose my accuracy, so what do I need to hit?
What do you mean you lose your accuracy?
Well,
oh, you lose 2 accuracy for red. So it's a 7+. Your weapon gives you a +2, right?
Yeah, and so I just lose the bonus for my weapon.
Yeah, so it's a 7+. Your weapon's a +2 or +1?
+2.
Okay.
So what's my fate at? Because I had to take a fate to do it.
I just gave it to you. It's 3 now.
Okay.
Oh, that's nothing.
Just
roll the damn dice.
I'm nervous. I'm
2
re-rolling
and 2.
Both of those. So give me 2 more fate, please and thank you.
If that'll not two
5.
More. That's an 8 and a 9.
Those are some hits.
There you go. So you're attacking the stabilizer.
Hey.
So you're going to roll 4 red dice.
Sure I am.
Need to roll 3. Okay. I got to run away. Again, I'll be back in 45 minutes if y'all are still going.
Okay.
My glasses. I can't see shit.
So I rolled 4 breaks.
Yep. So you're good. That is a wound.
This is good.
So perform the signature against the attacker.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. So I'll keep this over here.
You get your accuracy back though, and you get rid of dread.
You
That's
do.
That's true. I'm so okay with this.
So perform the signature. So it's gonna turn to face Anne.
Yeah. Great.
And please roll 2d10s. You're going to dodge on a 9+.
Yeah. It's a 2 and a 4, so I dodged on nothing.
Oh, no.
What do you mean, oh, no?
Josh is dead. Josh is about to take Noble. Okay. So he is now going to do 2 damage to you, Anne.
Okay. So I'm going to gain 2 dread. Puts me at 6.
2 danger.
Danger.
And you're going to take a level 2.
Why are you grabbing for 3? Look, let's not get excited.
50% chance Josh will be fine. 50% of the time, it works every
time. This will be
time.
The first time we draw one, yes. Yeah.
Unless Ant happens to draw something here that would, for some reason, affect you.
It's
no! I hate this! Stupid card! Look at my stupid skirt.
Woot! That means my obol on your unboxing was the first death. So now he's going to trample. So go ahead and run him forward.
Yeah.
5 spaces.
I get knocked down, right?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I feel like that was too many spaces.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah. Okay. That was great. So,
do you want me to hold the cards while you pull?
And can you put yourself back where you were? There you go. Don't look at it. Just don't look at it. Just hand it over, but don't look.
You died.
Josh is dead. Yay! Oh, wait, that wasn't EA.
No, it's not.
Good job being the tank, Josh. Are you sure? Is Twitch in the labyrinth, by the way? Wasn't that the long piece further away?
It should be one more further.
No.
1, 2, 3. Oh, no. Correct. Sorry.
Yeah, I know. That's why I had her corrected the first time. All right. So, wait. Anne can't discard skirt? No. She already did.
I didn't die.
I died.
Josh died.
Yeah, Josh is dead.
I discarded my skirt so that I didn't get disemboweled because I hate that card.
Can I rush to the butt?
So, Matt, you also have your Manos card, which lets you remove a condition. So you could get rid of your dread.
Oh, that's true.
And you get to leave tokens.
My Manos card, my hand card. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to gain a fate. Thank you, Josh. To discard that card. So I don't have dread anymore.
Wish we had remembered that last time.
Yeah. Can I run to the butt, Josh? Or Anne?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you would be a... No, because there's
6,
a wall.
Yes.
Oh, because he's half out of the wall?
You could also hit it from the side without rushing.
How?
Because he's right
here.
Oh,
his left butt cheek is hanging off the edge.
His left butt cheek is hanging off
the edge. All right, so I'm going to go... It's a level 3, so I am definitely going to rush.
Yeah.
I want that extra...
What do you need, openings or breaks?
Openings, please.
Okay, so then I have 6, so leave 3 openings.
You could leave 3?
Because I have 6.
Christ. I would prefer to leave 2 openings.
Oh, wait. I have rage. It's rage, not danger.
Yeah,
I'm
rage.
Sorry. It's 3. So I can leave 2 openings?
Yeah, 2 openings is good. Okay. So 2 openings. I am going to run up. Can you move me into his... Oh, I'm getting ahead of myself here.
Do you want to be in his blind spot?
I don't want to be in his blind spot.
4.
I need 2 more D10s. Oh, they're over here. Sorry. 1 more D10. I can't math today. So I'm rolling 3 dice. It is, I have 0 plus accuracy for me, so it's a 5 plus because of those 2 breaks you put in the pool. Okay.
No accuracy bonuses.
No accuracy bonuses. 6, 5, 1.
You want to reroll the 1?
What did I say hit? That's a 5 plus hit. So yeah, I'm going to take a fate to reroll a 1.
Okay. So you're at 5 fate now?
Yeah. Was
I think
7.
That's a reroll.
I think that's a reroll. I think it's a legit reroll.
Fine.
It's a 5.
Okay, that's
still
it
hits.
Hit. So I'm attacking the Hammerhead Wormhead for 6. Fail draw a major trauma card.
Oh, let's not do that.
Screw you, buddy. Okay, so what's my rage at right now?
Your rage is
2. Oh, 3.
3. Okay, so I'll have 1 reroll.
That's the other
cool.
head. Yeah.
So, I'm rolling 5 dice.
Okay.
That's the nice thing. Because I hit 3 times with my weapon. I have 1 natural, and I rushed.
Okay.
Cool.
And you get 1 reroll.
Yeah. Wow, that was awful. Okay, so I have 3. I can't get it. Because I only get 1 reroll. Mm-hmm. So it's a failure, so I'm going to draw a major trauma card. Major trauma.
Major trauma is only level 2.
Oh. What's the level 3?
Grave trauma. I'm glad I checked it before I had you call.
Yeah.
Grab it.
Well, this was a good one.
You've pulled lots of good ones.
That's what she said.
Ew.
Flood of Memories. Add a node to your Nemos card. You may immediately use actions from that card.
Oh, that's cool.
Yep. So I can now get rid of a status card again because I have my second node for my Nemos. That's neat. That's how you do it, folks. Son.
I don't think that's how that goes.
So that gets rid of this. I have how much danger, Josh? You want to turn your microphone on?
Your Bacchus. You have 8 danger, 3 rage, 5 fate.
8 danger? Shit. Yeah. I'm in bad shape.
Oh, yeah. You get one more danger and you're pulling a noble card.
Well, here's the cool thing. So I'm going to spend one more fate.
Okay, so that puts you at 6 fate?
Yeah. So I am at level 3. I am going to leave. What's up next? It's level 3. Who wants to go next? Who can go next?
I can't because I got knocked down on my turn. I have to wait till the end of my next turn to get rid of knockdown.
So Twitch can go next.
No. They're kind of stuck in the maze right now, and Anne's blocking the one entrance out. So.
But they're not. They took this turn to unexhaust their card anyways.
They're stuck in the maze. They can't get to the labyrinth.
They can go through me. I'm not an obstacle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and they could get to him.
No one else can go right now anyways. The monster has to take his turn. Mm-hmm. When they go, Anne's going to stand up.
No, because... No? Okay, so explain this. So here's...
Oh, okay. Sorry.
I still have to take a turn as not knocked down.
But yeah, they can move through, Anne.
Yeah.
I thought you couldn't move through other figures.
We've been playing that you could this entire time.
We have not.
Yes, we have.
We have not moved through each other at all.
We have. You want to check the rule book instead of arguing?
No.
Okay. Either way, I'm going to leave 3 openings and a break in the pool. Because I used my expose ability, which is when granted a opening or break token, I can spend a fate to grant 2 additional of that. So I'm going to double down on the openings.
Cannot move through Primordials or other Titans.
Told you we could.
Cannot.
Yeah, I told you.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Either way.
But I'm on the ground. You just walk over.
Leaving these openings for myself, it's fine. If that's the case, I'm going to change up what I do here. I'm going to actually leave 1 opening and 3. Oh, you know what? My weapon also leaves an opening by itself. So I am going to leave 2 openings and 3 breaks. Wow, I leave a lot of shit in the pool there. Okay.
And you upped your fate again, right? So you're at 6?
Yeah, I should be at 6 fate. Okay, so it's monster's turn now.
Yep. Level 3 AI.
Minotaur Logic. Priority target in range.
Twitch.
So go ahead and move and attack. So many openings will be great for Twitch if we survive.
Yep.
No, God, no. Sweaty.
Why?
So I could actually hit the damn thing, Anne. All right, so it is going to attack 1d10 for 8+. They do have 1 evasion because of their skirt, so it is a 7+. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat?
That's not terrible, a 7+.
No.
And they're playing a Sursigard with 5 fate.
That's 6.
So it's still...
Failure.
Comfortable enough to maybe reroll that? Take a fate and reroll?
What's their fate at?
5.
Yeah, because if they gain another one, they won't take the fate. They're going to take fate. Got to have fate. So let's reroll. 7+. They almost gain the alone fated card. And you think you're better off alone. Okay. 5. Okay, so they still get hit. So they're going to take 2 damage. 2 danger. So what's their danger?
6 danger now.
Cool. All right. After hit, gain the fear card. What's fear card?
It's a trauma card.
Trauma.
It's a Condition card, sorry.
Okay, so the fear, well, it's after hit. So let's see what they're taking for damage first.
No, hit first, then this is after trauma. So
oh,
I think
okay.
that happens first.
Gotcha, you're right. So fear, gain -2 accuracy. When you wound the primordial, discard this card and gain +1 accuracy. Battle aftermath. If you still have this card, gain the faded Nemos card. Oh, so this one still gives you a net negative.
Yep.
That's nifty.
When does the net negative go away?
At the end of the battle. And they got disarmed. Lose one weapon until the end of the battle. If you don't have any, gain a fate. Okay, so they're losing that weapon, so they still got their fists.
Oh, that sucks a lot.
Yeah, it does suck a lot. And now he's going to trample them.
Because they wouldn't want to lose
no,
their skirt.
No, you can't lose your fists.
They could lose their skirt, so they keep their weapon.
But that's true. You guys could lose your skirt to take to keep your weapon.
But you risk then not having your skirt if you pull like the disembowel card.
That is correct.
Ditch the skirt?
The other thing is, no one's going to be able to hit the damn bull because of the labyrinth. Okay, so risk it. They're ditching the skirt.
All right.
Get him naked. So he's going to trample, so move him forward 5 spaces.
Oh, this is going to suck because...
Why do you pick them up?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Matthew, if you don't like how I move the figures...
I really don't. Okay.
You can do it.
Okay, I will. So then he's going to labyrinth one. So right now we are on the L.
Which is the last piece that I do have.
So at least he can't poop anymore.
That's true.
You can make it poop around him.
Okay.
I guess.
Yeah. All right. If you could shuffle that up in. And that's going to be the end of the monster's turn. God, I love this fight. It's so awesome.
This is terrible.
So it's our turn now. And you can stand back up.
Do I stand back up? No, I don't. I just lose my knockdown card now.
Oh, you still had your knockdown card?
She got knocked down during her turn last turn.
Ooh. Well, no. Then she would stand up now.
No, at the end of your next turn. If you get it during your turn.
Oh, does it say the end of your next turn?
Yeah.
Is that why you had to say it so angrily?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so next turn you'll stand up. Twitch is going to lose their knockdown card.
Yeah.
So I'm going to stay exactly where I am. No, Jesus. Move me like 2 spaces to your left, Anne, and 1 space back. Or 2 spaces back.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. You're leaving both knockdown people.
Yeah. Because he doesn't trample when he runs to me.
Okay.
And then there should be ample buttocks space open available. Oh, no one needs that anymore. But still, I digress. Okay.
So that was a fun turn.
Yeah, that was our turn.
Is their weapon unexhausted?
Yeah. They don't have it anymore.
No, they
did.
Oh,
they've lost their
true.
Skirt.
That's right. I'm sorry. So you're doing supercharger. And yes, it is unexhausted now. This is going horribly. Okay, so furthest Titan in front in range.
Nobody.
Furthest Titan in sight in range.
You.
Nope.
Why?
Yes. No. It's Twitch. Furthest Titan in... I'm sorry, in range. I'm not in range.
It's only Twitch. And out of range.
And out of range? Okay, so shit.
So maybe you running away was not the right move?
Yeah, I did that wrong.
Actually, no. And it's just in range.
Perfect. I mean, oh no. So, Anne, roll 2d10s. How much fate do you have?
It actually says, are they considered insight?
We've been playing as them being insight in the labyrinth.
Okay.
Rolled a 9 and a 4.
You might want to just double check. If not, then we'll just move the thing.
Titan is insight. If the primordial can draw a line of sight to them, see line of sight.
Okay, so obstacle, indestructible passage. Indestructible if you crash into this tile.
Sees through red lines.
You may move through the path but cannot cross red lines. Does it see through red lines? Someone in the chat saying sees through the red lines. It's not actually spelled out on the labyrinth card. Okay, so supercharger, you roll 2d10.
if the line passes through an obstacle or red line, there is no line of sight.
Oh, so he would have done nothing then.
He would have done... Yeah, there's no target in sight, so yeah, he would have done nothing. So he would have done his routine, right?
Yeah, so no target, he escalates an AI card. Well, that sucks.
Thanks! Okay. Why does that suck?
Because now it's all level threes. Yeah, oh, no, there's a level one and a level two in there still. There you go.
That would have made a big difference the whole time. Yeah.
Yeah, it's yeah. fine.
Well, so then could they have attacked Twitch?
No.
So then Twitch really shouldn't be knocked down now.
They're fine. We're not remediating all of that. Okay, so who...
Primeval can walk over the pieces, but... They still block line of sight.
Yeah.
So we're hiding, like, under the walls, but he could just climb over the walls. You don't care.
Yeah. So some of the AI cards will say, won't say line of sight on them.
Yeah.
And actually, the first part of that, if he was facing the opposite direction, he would have attacked Anne. Because the first card was closest Titan in front in range.
Yeah. He hasn't had too many in sight cards. Most of them have been, like, in range or in front.
So you guys can go now and stand up.
Yeah.
Both stand up.
Would you like to move anywhere in particular? So Twitch could, like, they could actually start moving through the labyrinth this way if they want, so try and get out of the tangled mess.
3, 4, 5.
We could actually all start moving towards this more open area, which might be beneficial.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I don't know what you're counting. Also, I'm going to say since they lost their weapon, they lose their -1 speed.
They have their weapon still. They got out of their skirt.
If they would have lost their weapon, they would have lost their -1 speed.
+1 movement. 1, 2, 3.
What are you trying to figure out?
4, 5, 6. If there's any way possible that I could have reached it.
Not even a snowball's chance in hell. Okay. So do you guys want to start all moving towards the opening?
I think that makes sense.
Okay. So move Twitch 4 spaces that away, Anne.
1, 2, 3, 4. Is it 4 spaces?
Yep. They only have 4 movement. And you want to start running through the passage?
I don't decide where you want to go.
I'm taking the long way around. I'll let you guys fight this damn thing. Dan's gonna get beat up now. All right, everyone good?
Yep.
It's only a level 1 AI card. This is the last level 1 AI card, by the way. But, headbutt. Closest Titan in front and range.
Nobody.
Closest Titan in sight.
Nobody. So he escalates.
Yep.
Good. Great.
Okay, so Anne, you can go ahead and shuffle that.
What do you say? Please. Please is the magic word.
No. Do it now. Or else. Okay. I guess we'll start moving more towards that middle thing.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Weep. Now that you've ruined everything.
Ruined.
Stop, Matthew. You're so annoying. 1, 2, 3, 4 only goes here. I can't walk through Twitch. Twitch is going to have to move first.
Yeah, that's fine.
Are we moving towards the Titan?
I think move him into
to the primordial?
Just move him open into the clearing and then hope that he actually comes and finds us.
I mean, that blocks that.
Well, if they move here, Anne, then he'll have line of sight.
Yep.
Because he can see him down the hallway. Or or they can go here.
Where's my pencil?
And then lose out on line of sight.
Can he, though? Because it would be through the red wall.
He's in the labyrinth.
Center to center.
So he's not in the labyrinth. It would still be through the red wall.
Nope, because technically the red wall is on the center line. If he is two spaces by two spaces. So the red wall would be on the center line. So if they're point to point, it would be technically on...
It would be on to the left side of the red wall line?
It would be technically on top of, but it wouldn't be going through, if that makes sense. If you think of them as a two-dimensional system versus three-dimensional, then, yeah, it's planar.
One, two, three, four?
Yeah.
Where are you going?
You already
moved. It's waiting on you.
You're useless. One, two, three.
Oh, yeah. I'm not doing nearly as much as you're doing right now.
Chill on the nipple.
Okay. It's a monster's turn. Primordial's turn. Pizza man. Give her an attitude. Supercharger. Furthest Titan in front and range.
Nobody.
No. Furthest Titan in sight and range.
Nobody.
Is that not center to center in sight? No, I guess not.
No, it hits that other red wall line.
Center to center to who?
Does it?
Yeah, it's going to hit like...
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
going to clip
just
that.
The tip.
Just the tip.
Closest Titan in sight.
No one.
So he is going to escalate. Okay, so this is going to go to level 3. You can shuffle that up, Anne. He's going to fuck us up now. Now.
So now it's our turn?
Yep.
Twitch still has 4 movement. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can't do anything. Could rush. 5, 6. No, kidding. It only gives plus 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Can't do nothing.
Can they get in a spot where they'd be just out of his range?
2, 3, 4, 5. I can hit and I have rush because I reach 2. I can hit.
You can do it.
Am I still use? Is that Kratos pool correct right now?
Yeah.
Oh, they're saying they use the go down the labyrinth and they can hit it in the side.
Oh, one, two, three, four.
If they rush. Yep, they can rush and do that. Yeah, they could do that. I think that's probably a good idea anyways, because they can really mess it up.
That was a great, great idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so they're going
to... And then you can follow it up by going the other way and doing it.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Void.
5, because they're rushing, correct?
Yep.
Okay. So
6 rage now, 7 fate.
Those are high numbers.
It's at level 3 BP.
Oh, my goodness.
But there's breaks in the pool, and there's openings in the pool.
There's a shitload of breaks and openings. There's 2 openings, and there's 4 breaks in the pool.
So.
I think you're okay.
Yeah.
So 2d10s. Your weapon is going to hit. Oh, my God. What a horrible, horrible roll. It's a 7 plus. Their weapon is plus 1, so it's a 6 plus. They've got 2 openings in the pool, so it's a 4 plus.
They hit once.
Actually hit once.
They could reroll the 2 if they want.
If they don't reroll the 2, they're going to get two reds, a black, and a plus 1.
Everybody's saying reroll it.
Reroll? Okay, reroll.
But reroll just gives you an extra die. It's not going to take another piece. Like, I think they'll hit.
They hit. It's just, will they get enough breaks to wound?
To wound? I think so. They're starting off with 4 wounds off the bat.
No.
4 breaks. No. 5 breaks.
No.
Potentials.
Those are potentials.
Oh, that's right.
They rolled a 3, so it's only 1 hit.
Okay. So we'll see what happens here.
Okay.
I think it was the right move to try for it.
The tarp card.
End the attack. The Titan must pass a resistance 8 check. Well, shit. That gets rid of all of those glorious, glorious Kratos tokens that I put in the pool.
Yep.
Roll to 5. I think it's worth the fate to reroll it.
Yep. 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 Oh, God, why did I roll? he says as he rolls again. An 8.
They did it.
All right. Cool.
Stop me!
Go ahead and shuffle that, please. Now. Please do it now.
Okay. They do get to leave cards in the pool. Tokens
cards?
They need to hit.
Yeah.
I'd like you to leave lots of cards. Credit cards?
So what level are they at?
They're at level 6, so they can leave 3 tokens.
Ooh, that's nice.
Still too high.
So which tokens would you like to leave in the pool?
My accuracy is back up to a 2, so that means I need a 5 plus to hit, right?
It's a level 2 on top.
Open, break, break?
Yeah, I think you can't go wrong with either open, break, break, or open, break.
I like having more breaks because I can't roll the...
Open, break,
but there's
break.
Still potentials.
Yeah. Open, break, break.
So, and you're going to go... Are you Russian?
No, I'm Italian. Yes, I'm definitely rushing.
Okay, so you're going up to 6 fate. You have 4 rage.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should I do it from here and keep my distance? Yes, I should.
Can you...
Why don't you stand up when you do it, Anne?
I didn't push the table.
Can you attack him on the diagonal or you don't have enough movement?
Oh, she could.
I forgot where I was now.
Yeah, you can go here because that would have been... No.
No, you don't have enough.
You don't.
All right, go ahead and roll in.
Okay. So I'm rolling my 2 die because the card says I get 2 green ones.
So you've got, I think that's 2 hits. It's a 7 plus. There's 1 opening, so it's a 6 plus. You've got plus 2 accuracy, so it's a 4 plus.
Okay, so 7, 5, it's 2 hits. No crits.
That means you're going to get, since you rolled, you rushed, you're going to get 4 red dice.
Yes.
And you need that to attack the reinforced skull. So guess what, Anne? Look at that instinct.
Remove all the breaks that went in the pool.
Yep.
I have to roll 4 all on my own.
You get 2 rerolls.
Oh, that's true. And I'm going to need them. Can I reroll this?
Yeah.
That looks like a reroll. That looks like a regular reroll because it was on the corner of the board.
Sure. Cheater.
Thank you.
You got it.
Thank
that's
you.
4. All right, so that is a wound. So he's going to escalate that and get the damage. But, and take a fate. He's going to perform a signature against you. And, sorry, that Gaze of Temenos wasn't supposed to be in the deck. That's the tarp card. Now we add the tarp card in. Okay. So we made it a little bit harder on ourselves. Go team. Good job there. But he's going to perform the signature against you. So it's going to now move. So please displace Twitch.
I'm displacing them over here.
And
how?
Please roll 2d10s.
You just displace them next to the monster.
You made it so much harder on us. Reset. Start over.
A 2 and a 7.
All right. So it would be a 9 plus to hit you. So you're going to take 2 damage.
That gives me 8 danger.
Danger, danger.
Now you get a grave trauma.
So remember, you took your skirt off. Don't look at it. Oh. Oh.
I hate you, Matthew.
Overdread. Knock back 6. Gain the dread card. You don't have fear. I have fear. It's a good thing you don't have fear.
Okay. I may reduce knockbacks and pushbacks suffered by 1.
So knockback 5.
So knockback into the labyrinth and take a damage.
Yep. That is true. There you go.
So you're at 9 danger.
Yay.
And then I get dread, right?
Yes, you're going to get dread. So now your accuracy is terrible.
Well, it's regular. I just lose the accuracy from my weapon.
Yeah, that's true. It's like your weapons, your fists.
All because I definitely hit. That's poopy.
But he gets a damage, though. So, like...
And he escalates.
Well, when you put it that way. So we put another level 3 in there.
Okay.
And the trap card.
That's been in there.
No.
So...
So, you want to hear the good news?
Is that all level 3s? He's not going to escalate anymore?
He's not going to escalate his AI cards anymore. He's got all level 3 AI cards.
You want to shuffle the set locations?
No, not
wait
really.
A second. Okay, I want to back that up.
Why?
No, there's way too late to back it up now.
Okay, but look, I have a special ability. What does the active mean? I feel like maybe we should have just... Active means you just do it.
Active. When you are about to reveal the top BP card, gain one danger to choose any card from the BP deck instead.
You would have chose the level 3 card instead of a level 2?
Oh, I guess I could have. No, never mind.
Yeah. Okay. So that's fine.
So now they're all level 3?
Not BP. All the AIs are level 3.
What are you doing?
I'm going to move 5 spaces closer. What are you giving me that look for, Josh?
And what are you leaving in the pool?
I have 6.
4. So you can leave 2 tokens. And Twitch's shield should be exhausted.
Yep. Sure is.
A break and an opening?
Okay. I'm also going to use my second Nemos node to discard the fear card. So you can get rid of that for me. Thank you.
This so you don't get
the oh, it does.
Plus accuracy back.
Why not?
What's the card say?
When you wound the primordial, discard this card and gain an accuracy. So I just lose the 2 accuracy then?
Yes.
I don't gain the plus 1 back because I didn't wound?
Because you didn't wound.
Whatever.
So it gets up to you if you just want to keep the fear card and
I'll
have the chance of getting it back.
I'll keep the fear card.
It's... Your choice.
Nerd. All right.
You're so aggressive.
Because you have to be.
Aggressive.
And let's see who he's going to attack. That was all of our turns, right?
Yep.
Minotaur logic. Priority target token in range.
Floop.
So, Twitch, please roll 1d10 to 7+. This is nasty. This is nasty. Minotaur logic. It's a 4. Okay. So there's that.
8 damage.
Yep. So they're going to take 2 damage. How much fate do they have?
9.
9.
Hmm. So they're going to gain the alone fated Nemos card. Is that a good one or a bad one?
Don't know.
They're going to gain the fear card. So they're going to lose 2 accuracy. He's going to perform trample.
This is definitely 2 people's.
Just...
That's my fault. I know I'm not supposed to roll, but I did it anyways.
Just
what are we getting the
fear? Oh, I'm sorry, alone Nemus card.
Have you been?
There was no one there for you.
All right. There was no one there for you. Boo. If at the end of your turn you're more than 7 spaces from all other Titans, gain 2 fate.
Separation anxiety.
Yeah, pretty much. Guys, don't leave me. Now he is going to trample. So
no,
and
they need to draw a trauma card first. They have a chance to...
Oh, yeah, you're right. They have a chance to actually get out of the way.
Yeah.
But it's level 9, or a level 3 trauma card, right?
Yep. It's a grave trauma.
Grave.
Grave jingle.
Not even touching it.
You want to pull him? Or?
No, let go. I'm going to hold them.
Heart of the cards, heart of the cards. This one. See pattern. Look at the top AI and BP card. You may put each card on the bottom or on the top of their respectful decks and gain a scroll.
You don't need any more scrolls, so.
Oh, yeah.
Now he's going to trample them.
What do the scrolls do?
Did he want to look at the AI or the
It says
BP?
Both.
Oh, both?
Okay. Yeah, that's a good one.
Why don't you put it up and I can read it on the screen?
So furthest Titan in front in range. Furthest Titan in sight in range. It's going to attack Twitch. No. Yeah. Yeah, probably. I don't know. Each hit does 4. Gain the knockout card. That's nasty. I'm going to put it on the top or the bottom?
The bottom?
I mean, the next one's level 3 also.
Well, yeah. It's also Twitch's choice. So just give them a little bit to answer.
So, oh, yeah. So top BP card is this one here.
Oh, yeah, that one. If you guys would like to keep that on the top for the BP card.
So... Here's the thing, though.
Yeah.
He's only got 2 health left.
Yeah.
If you hit a level 3, you do double damage. He's dead.
What do you mean if you hit a level 3, you do double damage?
If you wound a level 3 card, they typically do double damage.
Oh.
This one would have him draw an AI card and immediately perform it against the attacker as well.
Risk it for the win. BP bottom.
BP
AI
bottom.
Top.
Because that's the only level 1. Everything else is level 3 in that deck, right?
That's the only level 2, but
yes,
yeah, BP bottom. So both of them went to the bottom. So now we have a level 3 AI and a level 3 BP.
So now he's going to trample them. So run full forward a straight line.
Destroys the
city, so we gate a doom.
Doom!
They're knocked down. But they'll get up again. And then he's going to labyrinth one, but he's got no more poop.
Can't poop no more. He's fizzled out.
So it's our turn.
He's
with no one
pooping
close enough to do anything.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
If you could actually do it, Anne.
Yeah, I could.
You can't.
Why?
You have dread. You can only attack from the blind spot.
Ba-dum-ba-dum.
I have reach 2. Why is that not the blind spot?
Because you're not in the blind spot.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I only get plus 1 for 6.
Yep. Ba-dum-ba-dum-ba-dum. So Twitch is going to go. They're going to discard their card. So next turn, they'll stand up.
I think I want to move
closest or you get hit.
What's its range?
5.
5.
So shouldn't I stay 6 spaces out so that I can rush next time and I'm still out of his range?
I would also not stand directly in front of him in case he goes and tramples.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
But I would go off to the side if you can.
So maybe like here?
Yeah, I would go there.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's fine.
Play it safe for a turn. Matt adds a ton to the Kratos table, right? Yeah, I could. That would probably be the right thing to do.
You're in range, so you want to take one step back.
And then, Anne, if you could move me 5 spaces closer as well.
6. How many?
5.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Pretty much right behind you. Yeah. You know that it's going to be a home run on top now, too. Yeah.
Could be.
Woohoo.
We'll find out.
Woohoo. Bow to the labyrinth. Closest Titan in front in range.
Nobody.
Closest Titan in sight. That's Twitch.
Oh, no.
Chat, please roll a d10. It is a magic.
Magic.
That means he doesn't move, right?
Correct.
So oh.
Okay, sorry.
At least that's how we're interpreting it. They rolled a 9. They don't take damage.
That's great. Awesome. Or the dread card, because they already got that. Well, they already have fear.
Yep. So no trauma, no nothing then.
Really?
Yeah, because they didn't take a trauma, so they wouldn't do this.
So okay. That's the end of its turn?
Well, dang it, Bobby.
Twitch stands up now, right?
They do stand up now.
Yep.
And when they're knocked down, they can't spend any of those activations, right? So they couldn't have unexhausted their weapon. So they can unexhaust their weapon now, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Can they knock down means they can't unexhaust their weapon? Like, I feel like they should have still been able to.
Nope, you can't use any actions.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
How many spaces away from the monster am I?
Well, can't move through me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay.
I feel like you should have gone here, where I put you.
Yeah.
Because I need you to leave a bunch of stuff in the pool so that I can do this hit.
Yep.
I mean, it's... But now I have dread again, so I've lost my accuracy.
We're much better at dodging when we're knocked down.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
I'm going to move 5 spaces closer up the side of the board.
This way?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yep. I would suggest Twitch unexhaust their weapon and move away.
They're talking about punching it.
They can shatter fist, they're saying. I forgot what shatter fist is. How much damage do they have?
Danger 8+.
Eight?
When you attack, gain 1 danger to gain 1 break.
I would say let's save that and go for the home run. Next turn. We have to tank one more turn.
Should they move away?
I would say have them move a little bit away, so that way it would rather attack me, because I still have my skirt.
Shadowmar says,
pfft. You want to scoot him
We
away?
Could rush and then shatter fist.
Oh, Jesus.
Got you're at 9 fate, so I don't think you can take a fate to go to 10.
Yeah, definitely don't rush.
Oh, that's right.
I don't think you can purposely take an additional
Oh,
fate.
Really?
I think once you're at 9, you can't take any more fate.
So scoot him to the side. It's fine. They'll be fine. And what are you doing with your turn? You can stay where you are.
I want to make sure that we're doing what they want to do.
I'm asking what you're doing.
Even if we don't agree with their choices.
I vote the horrible option of Shatterfist. Rest of chat?
They could Shatterfist into it, leave some openings and some breaks for Twitch to do it.
Put up a poll, Josh. Do it. Never mind. They want to do it.
Yep.
Do it. Okay. We're doing it live. Okay.
So they're going to 9 danger. Jesus.
They're not rushing. They can't.
They're attacking with their fists. So it's 2d10s.
They're now going to be at how much? At 9 danger? Jeez, to gain a break.
6 plus to hit.
Okay. With the opening?
Yeah. It's a 7 plus naturally.
2 hits.
So good.
The tarp card. Oh, that's horrible.
Well, shit.
I think we're all just kind of speechless.
My fists.
You did. You saved us from that.
They can't take a fate.
Nope.
So they take 3 damage. They can't take any more damage. So they're good. They take 3 fate. They're going to have to draw a...
What do you mean they can't take... Don't they have to draw an obol card because they're going to exceed 9 damage? 9 danger? I feel like they take an obol card for each of those.
No, you don't think it for... It's not for each.
I'm so proud of the fact that you stopped halfway through immediately arguing with me to go and check. But then, after I was so proud of you, in the moment that I felt proud of you, you continued on. But at least there was a pause. Home and ready to pay attention.
This is going above 9 forces you to draw a card.
So what are they at now, Josh?
They're at 9.
So 3 plus 9.
Makes them go over
so
once. Not you don't add it.
Right, so they would draw a card.
Once.
You were saying they wouldn't
draw
any cards.
No, she was saying they would draw 3 cards.
Oh, she was very wrong.
Like,
but you were wrong, too.
No. That they would draw a card.
No, she meant a card for each of those. So both the fate as well as the danger.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm not drawing that shit. I ain't gonna be responsible for this.
Are the cards?
They live. That's the same noise I make when I see a cute puppy, by the way.
Okay, so they're gonna gain 3 fate. It's not an obol, it's one of those, right?
It's one of these cards.
Oh, why, with your tiny T-Rex arms, did you think you were gonna make it across the table? Now something worse than a noble.
Oh my god. Gain 2 danger and draw a trauma card.
So does that mean they have to do an obol card again?
Yep.
Oh my god.
Obol again!
Don't pick wrong, Matt. I can't even look.
No! I second guess myself too. Obol, you mean oh boy? No. There's 5 cards in the deck. So there's a 20% chance of us getting the tarp card at this point.
Can we just take it out because you put it in too soon?
Well, our fist did shatter. They get the leaf token still.
Do they?
I think they should.
I don't know if that
Their hits still hit.
That's true. The hit does still hit.
And then.
So what's their rage at?
The Bulls' butt just sucked them up.
What's their rage at?
It's at 6.
So they get to leave 3 tokens.
Or 7,
where
actually.
It's in the rule book, the order of leaving the Kratos tokens.
Whatever. It's still 3 tokens. Which tokens do you want to leave, guys?
Openings for Anne.
I want to hit
there's
after
level
Matt.
Level 1 body part card out there? Okay.
Oh, there's level 1 body part. That's not what I wanted.
But attack canceled. It still hit, though. It canceled the wound.
Yeah.
I think. I don't know. Check the rules. Get them off the board. They're dead. So that's now the Bulls' turn, right?
Who gets priority token?
You do.
Yeah.
Why? Why did you say yes?
Why did I say yes what?
That I get the priority token.
The break is just a +1 break. It's not a break token, I think. It's just a free break. I could be wrong, but...
Yeah, just check the rules.
So it's the Primordial's turn now.
Anne never went.
I never went.
You never went?
No.
Oh. It's a level 1 BP. You might want to go for it.
You didn't go either, did you?
I did. I moved. I couldn't reach the monster.
I didn't move.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
It's a level 1. You might not actually want to rush.
I have to reach it.
Oh, do you?
Because I still have Dread, so I have to hit the blind spot.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
But I want to get rid of this Dread.
Then you can set me up to go for the killing blow. As much as that pains you, I'm sure.
It really, really does. It really. And she'd go, let's leave 3 openings for her.
At the end of your attack, you may apply any tokens. This is if you hit.
Okay. I really don't want to give you the hitting killing blow. I really hope you get the trap card.
So you're getting a rage and a fate.
Yep.
Devil's advocate there is that it says cancel attack, and that specifically says at the end of your attack.
Does it say cancel or the attack ends?
It says cancel. I want to say it says cancel.
Why am I rolling? I only rolled 2.
We're keeping that because we made it harder on ourselves.
Okay. I rolled 1 hit.
You want to take a fate to...
No.
Okay.
No, I don't.
You're attacking the hide mail. 3.
You get 3 red dice.
Oh, okay.
You have 5 rage. Oh, no, you get 4 dice.
Why 4 dice?
Because you get +1 at 5 rage.
Oh, yeah.
And you get 2 rerolls.
That's true. You got it.
3.
You got it.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so that is a wound. So he is going to try to shit something out. And now he's going to escalate.
Tank's empty.
Tank's empty. Josh, please reduce the monster's life total by 1. And can you shuffle that up, please?
Yes, and now I lose my Dread card. Thank you. Accuracy back.
Okay, so he doesn't escalate any more AI cards. Because they're all level 3.
Bless you. And then you did not. You went and you couldn't reach.
Yeah, so it's the monster's turn.
Oh, God, I hope I don't die.
Ew. He's attacking with his true horn of the other side. What?
Oh, and you have to leave tokens.
What's the other... Oh, yeah, what's the tokens?
How many rage do I have? 5? I get to leave 2 tokens? Yep. What do you need?
Sorry, I want to know what the BP card is on top.
What's going to be on top?
You can stop shuffling anytime
it's today.
It's
going to be a 3. They're all 3s.
No, there's a couple of 2s in there.
The only benefit is you get your accuracy back.
Yeah. So it is a level 3. I would like some breaks.
Okay. So then put 2 breaks in the pool.
You could do 3.
You still have fear, don't you? So you have -2 accuracy?
Are you a 5 or a 6, Anne?
5.
Oh, I thought you were at 6. Sorry.
No.
Matt, you still have fear, don't you?
Yes. So you have -2 accuracy. You sure or you still want the breaks?
Yeah, otherwise I'm not going to wound the damn thing. I don't know. Shit.
And the Dread doesn't stack and give you a heart attack.
Yes, I am going to take the breaks. Okay.
All right, so what is he doing? Which is true horn?
He's attacking with his other horn. Priority target in range.
Me!
Okay, so 1d10 and 8+. You took your skirt off, 9+.
It's an 8.
Oh, it'd been great if you had your skirt on still. It's going to do 4 damage to you.
Yeah, I'm pulling an oval card.
Oh, yeah, you sure are.
Oh, did you want to make that a 13? Is that why you're reaching over there?
Gain the bleeding card, Anne. The bleeding status card.
Let's make sure I don't die.
Well, hold on. This happens first. At the start of your turn, place one token on this card. Draw trauma cards at plus one danger for each bleed that you have.
Mm-hmm.
You or an adjacent Titan can remove two for an activation. If there are no tokens on this card, discard this card and subtract one danger. So you can actually heal up a little bit. Or you can die. Run the two. Don't look at it. Just hand it over. That's what you picked? Good choice. And now he's going to try to shit twice.
And he doesn't.
Whew. Shit's off the board anyway.
That's nice of him. Oh, my God.
Okay. It's our turn.
Anne could go... Anne has a better chance to hit and does the breaks in there.
Because my accuracy is back?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're better here, Anne.
You could rush it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm rushing.
Or you could use your once in a million. No, that would make you draw a card.
Yeah, no. I'm going to rush.
So you also got rid of Dread because you wounded the monster.
Yeah, so I'm going to move there. All of three spaces.
Okay.
2d10s.
5 plus.
Oh, at the start of your turn, place a bleed token. So I should have a bleed token. 7 and a 1.
One hit. So you have two breaks in the pool. You're rolling four dice, right? Three dice.
Three.
One natural, one from her weapon, one for rushing. Oh, I'm sorry, and then one from her rage. So four dice, yeah. Oh. You're attacking the will of Temenos. It's
a
7. Oh, shit! 5, you have 6. You need one more because you've got one in the pool.
Reroll the... You get 2 rerolls.
Yeah, you do get 2 rerolls.
Oh, my God.
You get one more reroll.
That's a potential.
You want to reroll that one that's right there instead of reaching across the table?
You got it. All
high fives.
All
high
that
fives.
Yeeting.
Just high-fiving. Ready
but,
for it.
Hold on.
What do you mean?
Before you damage... His instinct occurs, right? Yeah. So you're going to gain 3 fate. Sorry.
Do you want to add that trap card to the deck?
It's already there. Get wrecked, bully. A bully wooly. Oh, no.
That better not be you die.
Not you die. You die. Another random Titan suffers gains 2... 2 rage, 2 fate, and 2 danger, and suffers knockdown. But I don't draw a card from that.
You go up to 10, so yeah, you would.
I would draw one.
Yep,
that's amazing. Something else.
Man. Holy! Do you know what this is, Matt?
That's payback.
This is Galapagos. We're literally on the island that I'm shooting you in the face. Oh my God, this is so good. Now I know why you wanted to do this so bad. What a great feeling. If you die.
I'm good.
Aww.
I'm good. Good, fam. Good. All right. Wound. Remove all breaks. Draw and perform an AI against the attacker.
He's dead.
But he's dead first.
Raid!
You shall not raid!
My favorite one.
It really is pretty favorite. Hello!
Hi!
You called us just as we won. So, yay! Oh, wow. If you would have critted this one right away, you just automatically
it dies.
Win. It's just good. That's interesting, though, because look, you've severed the link.
How we beat you done for once.
But so that... That means that something else is controlling these primordials, that they're not, like, individual monsters. Like
he's a robot.
This one's a robot.
He poops out mazes.
Yep, he does poop out mazes. So, we win. We're going to do all the story event now, right? We're going to do the exploration phase. I'm kidding. I have to go home. It's the Matrix. It's electric. Boogie, woogie, woogie. Aftermath?
Yeah.
How many Titans got destroyed?
Two. Surprisingly. Almost three. Almost four. We almost all died. It was actually a really tight one.
Yeah, it was. Yeah.
Victory. Well, we also made it harder for ourselves with that trap card in there.
Yeah.
But I blame Josh for that. This was no mere chance meeting. This was a tarp. The forces opposing you sense your growing strength.
I almost spit out my drink.
Almost. It doesn't count.
Sub.
No. The forces opposing you sensed your growing strength, saw with their own eyes the power wielded by the Titans. You've bested the Hecaton more than once. A more powerful servant was sent to deal with you, and you bested it too.
Oh, yeah. Get wrecked.
You feel euphoric when you return to the Argo, yet no celebration awaits you.
That's so lame. That sounds like my life.
Just a slender man in tattered robe. You have defeated the Bull of the Labyrinth. A new chapter of The Truth of the Labyrinth begins. Now go to paragraph The True Beginning, 0036 in the storybook.
The slender man in the tattered robe waiting for me at home is Michael.
0036 00. Damn it, sexy clam. Celebrate.
Dance for me, clam man.
I feel like that's a quote if I ever heard one. Dance for me, clam man.
I want him to dance.
Flex your bivalve.
What's the one where they do with the finger?
Like the castanets? Zero, zero, 0036. Congratulations!
You've
won the prelude!
We beat the game!
Yay!
There were more than a dozen ways to reach this point, each based on your decisions. Those decisions would follow you to the end of the campaign and shape your game, both narratively and mechanically. Is Minos in a league with the Simarchy? Simarchy? Whatever. Or is he their prisoner? Is he even alive? What about his daughters? Have they made you an enemy of the state? Or are you stalwart allies in the fight against the Labyrinth? Each of those questions poses story implications, but also informs your mechanical options. All this and more awaits you in the final game of Aeon Trespass Odyssey. Thank you for playing the prelude.
Yay! All the bits and bobs said clam tenets, and that was funny.
We did it!
We did it!
Hooray! Nip slip. All right, so thank you all for joining us this evening. This is going to conclude today's presentation and the prelude for Twitch Plays Aeon Trespass Odyssey. Thank you so much for joining us. We had a blast with this. This game just wrapped up on Kickstarter 2 days ago.
Yeah.
And we have had a lot of fun with the pleasure of showing this one off for you fine folks at home. But if you want to check out more of the stuff that's coming out here at Twist Gaming, join us next week, Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, for our continuation of Twitch Plays Madara, the unintentional Alamec one, where we have an ongoing campaign of Madara with these two fun people.
It's Matless Mondays.
Matless Madara Mondays. So, Josh, give us a brief glimpse of what happened last episode.
Zeke and
give
both
us
died.
A brief recap.
Josh died twice.
Cool. Then join us on Tuesdays for more Twitch Plays fun with Twitch Plays Kingdom Death Monster, where we have an ongoing campaign of KDM with you guys controlling one of the characters, rolling some dice, and making some bad decisions with us. We're going into Lantern Year
3
of the People of the Skull variant campaign, where things are, you know, bony. no expansion so far. For every boss that we beat, you see the boss in the top right-hand side of your screen there. For every boss that we beat, we are going to add an expansion into our Twitch Plays KDM campaign. Whenever we get one of those bosses beat as well, we do a giveaway. So yeah. The bosses,
oh,
just like that. Thank you for the $5.
Oh!
Bobs.
Okay, that's
hooray
my...
Hooray for winning. Way to go, Anne. Josh, I appreciate your toga. Cheers.
Oh, okay.
Hurry up.
Okay.
How we beat that boss.
So by bits and tips?
Yep.
and by people following, people subscribing.
Yep. So make sure that if you have Amazon Prime, you've got Twitch Prime, which means you get one free sub every month. We'd love it if you use it on us. Subscribers get a bunch of goodies. They get special emotes that they can use. They get more entries into all the giveaways that we do. They get more entries into the polls that we are voting for, so their votes count more. We have monthly subscriber coupons for our Twist Gaming store. And what other stuff? There's some other stuff, too, I'm sure.
Yeah, there's other stuff.
Subscriber-only Discord channel. I think we still have a Minecraft server.
We do. Yeah, it's there.
Is it chaos in there?
I have no idea. I haven't logged in a bit. The server might be off at the moment. No one's told me. I don't know.
Yeah, whatever. But yeah, lots of cool stuff there. Any tips, bits, cheers, and all that fun stuff that go directly back into funding the stream. So that's getting us more goodies for giveaways, giving us better equipment so we can bring you a higher quality product, and all of that fun stuff as well. We do a lot of streaming from different conventions. We will be at PAX Unplugged later this year, so stay tuned for some information on what kind of presence we'll have there. And let us know what you want to see for our next upcoming Wednesday streams, because as you can see, we just finished up on Twitch Plays and Trespass Odyssey. One of our options that we do have is Anne screaming in the background. Yeah, no one can hear you, Anne. This is great. So one of the things we do, we have some of our filler shows.
Wait, Ellie, no, you got, you did 15, you did 5, so that's 20. So she's get it in a toga now.
Yep. She's doing it. She's just slow. What was I going to say? Oh, we've got some filler streams that we do. We've got our
Gauntlet
stream, where we play competitive games, head-to-head games with each other to find out who the best board gamer here at Twist Gaming is. It's been a while since we did one. I don't remember who's winning. It's either you or me. It's close.
There's a command for it.
There is. The question is, do you remember the command for it?
That's you.
Oh, yeah.
I'm at 17.
I'm so good. Then, when we feel like being more cooperative, we've got the bro-op. we play cooperative games and bro down in the process.
And we have our spotlights, which
yep.
We are working on getting a few scheduled at the moment. So.
Absolutely. So we're super excited to potentially bring you some more spotlights for games just coming out into the biz.
So we're looking at doing we're talking to USAopoly, and they want to do a spotlight for both.
Well, just don't spill the beans
cool
just
games.
Yet. Some
do
cool
games.
Some really cool games.
We have an Ultra Pro spotlight we still need to do.
Yep.
And we're also going to do that Snell game. The racing game. From Dice Archon. Snails, right?
What?
Omar?
That is not snails.
What is it?
It is go-karts.
I thought it was snails.
No.
It was like snails and go-karts or something like
no.
that.
No. It's people in go-karts.
What's the name of the game?
Safari Turbo.
Whatever. I thought it was snails. I don't know
is
why.
Is it because the movie... Turbo was a dog.
No, Turbo was the snail, wasn't it? There was a snail movie.
I think
movie.
There was a snail in it, but Turbo was
no,
a...
No, there was a
Oh, no, it's
snail
Bolt
movie.
I'm thinking
You're
of.
You're thinking of Bolt.
Yeah.
I think Turbo was the snail movie.
Go-karts, snails.
Go-kart, snails.
What's
the
difference? About time. You know what the best part of it is? No one can hear Anne.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's everyone's favorite part of the stream.
Yep. When she goes away. Josh is correct.
About what?
Turbo, the snail movie. Yeah. I got confused with Bolt.
That's a dog.
Yeah, I know. Turbo is about a snail. Nice! Nice! That's what she said.
It, like, hooks into the costume.
That's what she said. That's cool. I like the hairpiece.
Thank you.
Oh, they meant your toupee.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, she's naturally bald. She's got alopecia.
That's not nice.
I don't know why I thought this was a snail.
Are you really doubling down right now and checking that the game doesn't have a snail?
He's convinced. How the hell did you think that was a snail?
I don't know. I thought it had snails.
Did you think it was snail turbo?
I don't don't know.
What if it was Rastafari Turbo? It was a game about Jamaican racing.
Sled racing?
Yeah, Jamaican bobsledding. It's perfect.
Look at this little cape.
It's not a cape. It's a streamer.
No, this is a streamer.
Oh, boy. All right, so anything else, folks?
I think that's it. Did we get the recording yet or no?
No.
Oh. If you watch this on video on demand?
If you're watching us on video on demand, make sure you... Oh, they could hear you. You got a loud mouth.
Yeah.
What were you handing me in?
I got the gold hair piece like my...
but yeah, anything else that you wanted to say while we have the recording going? I'm being serious here. If there's something you want me to communicate in.
We got the Funko Games.
We got the Funko Games.
And I was thinking maybe next Wednesday.
And Anne was thinking that maybe next Wednesday... Since the games are getting released to the public in October, we can play that one. Is it cooperative or competitive?
It's teams.
It's teams. So I have we got the DC one, we got the Golden Girls one, which is only a two-player, and we got Harry Potter. So maybe we can put up a poll and see.
That's a great idea. We'll put up a poll. For all of you watching live and on video on demand, make sure you're joining us so you can vote in the poll. We'll do a social media poll to see which of these Funkoverse games you want us to play next Wednesday on our, I guess it's a Gauntlet stream?
I guess so.
Board game.
You gotta try and make it. Board game Gauntlet!
But with that, thank you all for joining us this evening. We really liked playing Aeon Trespass Odyssey with you, and we look forward to the next round of games that we get to play along with our fine viewers at home. Signing off for now, though, I'm Matt.
I'm Ian.
I'm Josh.
Good night, everyone.
Bye.